studios in Orlando, Florida. It's WCW Pro on TBS. Hi, everyone. Good morning. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. And Larry the Giant has shocked the wrestling world. He has beaten the Nature Boy Ric Flair for the World Heavyweight Championship. The question now is, can anybody beat the Giant?
Shocked the world, but the prophecies were already written down. You know, if you read the ancient prophets, it is already foretold, Chris, that at the end of the age, who shall be able to stand against the beast?
Also, Dusty, well, pretty profound. In this hour, we'll take the fans back to Nitro, and we'll show them Lord Steven Regal really putting it to the Belfast Bruiser in a match that may end the career of the Bruiser.
Christopher Groove, sometime, Larry, even profound as he is, nails it right on the head. So true about the new champion of the world, the Giant. The Belfast Bruiser lost Steven Regal this past Monday Nitro. Got into a disarray, cab cars fight in the parking lot situation with the Belfast Bruiser coming out on the bad end of it. We're going to see so much today on the Pro that it just scared me half to death. I might have to take my medicine.
All right, a hot hour. We're kicking it off here on WCW on TBS. We take you to the ring right now. Good look there at the jam-packed Universal Studios in Orlando, Florida, the WCW Pro Arena. And we're about to see the Armstrongs make their appearance. And gentlemen, they are up against two of the biggest men to ever step foot in the squared circle.
Yes, but the news is out all over town. The biggest man of them all, the Giant, the new world heavyweight wrestling champion. And I tell you what, guys, we will look at how that really transpired in this past Nitro later on today, and what a program we got.
Yeah, we will see that a little bit later. In fact, you know, you may want to keep that as a keeper tape, because it may be the last time in a long time that you see the World Heavyweight Championship change hands, and out come the Shark and the One Man Game.
Yeah, look at the size of these two guys, Shark, One Man Game. Just a mass of humanity, but both of these guys look small in comparison to the new heavyweight champion.
Look at the fans there who are enjoying the action that's about to start here at the Pro Arena. Gentlemen, how do you, if you're the Armstrong brothers, deal with guys like this?
Well, I tell you what, right here on the Pro with the big boys play, you are in this situation. Opportunity knocking on your door. Got to use your speed if you're the Armstrong. Got to stay away from the power. Don't let the big guys get on top of you, or they'll squash you like a grape right here this morning on the Pro.
Yeah, I think the Armstrongs should just call Bellevue now and reserve a side-by-side room so their dad, Bullet Bob, can come in and give him flowers and candy.
Well, that's not true. They can have
look at these
situation.
Two. There you go. They have a chance here.
Well, they started off hot and heavy right here on the Pro. Drop kick. Well, got him. Look at that, Chris. He's a waving.
Yeah, indeed he did. Armstrong with a second drop kick. Caught him right on the shoulder. That gang goes down. We've got a two count, but he kicks out.
Yeah, Dad, he just pushed Steve Armstrong up like a piece of paper. Here comes Scott, very fast, aggressive, but the smallest of the Armstrong boys, and giving up way too much size. Both these Armstrongs aren't as big as the one-man gang.
Well, Dusty, you said we're going to see the World Heavyweight Championship change hands in footage from Nitro just a little bit later in this hour. We'll also take the fans to footage. Oh, look at that from Shark. Yes, a Mac. The footage from that Lord Steven Regal Belfast Bruiser parking lot brawl. Speculation that match may be responsible for the conclusion of the career of the Belfast Bruiser, and the conclusion of the career of Steve Armstrong. Well, maybe the offing in this match here.
Yeah, that looked like one of the sandwiches. They got him in a sandwich situation right there, sandwiched him into the corner, and they made a sandwich of him right here on the Pro. We're going to talk about, yes, Larry Legend, about the Belfast Bruiser, Lost Steven Regal moving on up the line. What a brutal competition that was on this past Nitro.
Oh, talk about brutality right there. He may be down to three Armstrong brothers after this match. Look at the size difference here. Shark, big man, well-coordinated. Look at that. He zeroed in on the small of the back, dropped that elbow. This guy's having Armstrongs for breakfast.
Well, Drake, Steve Armstrong, what is this? He's biting him, and the referee, I think, can see it. Man.
Whoa.
The one-man gang and the Shark are proving a very good team this morning here on the Pro.
Well, it's unusual to see guys of this size to be so agile and be able to move like they can. And they really, and they know all the moves and all the holds right there. Nice belly to belly by Sharp. Got him almost in a shark attack situation. And his partner don't give away no height, don't give away no poundage. I mean, they both the same size.
Indeed, unlike so many big men, neither Shark nor the one-man gang are slow or ponderous or lacking in aerobic capacity. Oh, wait a minute. He's fast, but not fast enough, apparently, for Steve Armstrong as he moves out of the way. And the one-man gang comes in, realize, oh, through the legs of one, through the other, and Scotty is in.
Well, he takes Scott and fresh Armstrong, trying his best, but he didn't have enough size. Look at right there, double-teaming both Armstrong boys, but still he don't have enough. Oh, he went down.
Well, they got him off his feet right there.
He went out.
Yeah, he got clubbed. He really got clubbed right there. Caught him in midair. Put him to waste.
And now this could be the beginning of the end now for the Armstrong brothers. Are we going to see the big splash, the 747? He gives the signal, the one-man gang gets momentum, and he's... Oh, that is it. Scotty Armstrong may be out. The three count.
Maybe out.
Yeah, good point. Is out. The one-man gang and the Shark. Victorious this morning over the Armstrong brothers.
Good news for Bullet Bob. Now he's only down to two child supports.
Stay on them all. When we come back, footage from WCW Monday Nitro, that brutal battle between the Belfast Bruiser and Lord Steven Regal in the parking lot. A brutal parking lot brawl between Lord Steven Regal and the Belfast Bruiser. We take you back to Nitro. There is some concern about whether the Belfast Bruiser can continue in this very difficult sport we call the sport of kings, professional wrestling. Dusty, as you know, it's Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery. Lord Steven Regal and the Belfast Bruiser were supposed to team up.
Well, I tell you what, you know, in that situation, it was brutality at its best, and I guarantee you, that was the parking lot fight, the end-all parking lot fight.
Oh, yeah.
And cars were bashing, hands were bashing, backs were hurt, and the Belfast Bruiser, who I really believe might have come out on the top of that thing right there, Lord Steven Regal now turned that thing around in his favor. What a brutal thing that was on this past Monday Nitro.
One thing I've learned after my 20 glorious years is whenever you fight a steel object, the steel object wins.
That's a good call, Larry.
Thank you.
Welcome.
So as we said, at this point anyway, in Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery, it's Lord Steven Regal and the Belfast Bruiser against this man, BK Wall Street, and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Now, we're going to see Hacksaw a little bit later in this hour in the main event against Ric Flair. And speaking of Lord Steven Regal,
yes,
this Monday night,
yes,
on Nitro, special 7 p.m. start time, Sting takes on Lord Steven Regal.
Yeah, WCW Monday Nitro is going to be on fire once again this Monday night, 7 o'clock, as you said. Sting, Lord Steven Regal, the Macho Man, cuff to knot against Hugh Morris. And it will be a gigantic event on Nitro, the hottest show on Monday night. And I guarantee you, everybody going to be watching that thing right here. Pez Watley got his work cut out from a veteran, as Watley is. But I tell you what, as we said before, BK Wall Street just steadily, Larry, gets victory after victory after victory. Oh, go with it, Pez. Do it, baby. Go on,
girl.
There you are. Shake your booty. Shake your booty. Yeah, shake your booty.
What? Are you done?
Okay.
Well, I think Wall Street is a lot smoother in there. I mean, Pistol Pez, more of an emotional... For Pete's sake.
No, Pez.
Whatever.
Pistol Pete Pez, I like it. Larry made one up. That's good.
Our Dragon Twist, now the reversal there by Pistol Pete Pez. What?
Not Pistol Pete Pez, it's what he said.
Well, it's hard to ignore him.
Well, Pez Wally, as we said, an athlete that he is, he can fight fire with fire. He's been used to being down there on the mat too, like BK Wall Street. So right now, Pez got his game plan working real good right here on the Pro this morning. Big news talking about you big guys, the Giant, tonight on WCW Saturday Night, defends that title against Lex Luger. We're going to talk about that later on in the program. But what a Saturday night on the mothership that will be tonight.
You know, an intrigue around the match tonight with Lex Luger and the Giant. Where will stand the presence of the mastermind,
who?
Jimmy Hart?
Oh, yeah, Sting of the Grab, Jimmy Hart.
You were talking about fighting fire with fire, Dusty. Speaking of fire, the team of Fire and Ice will be here in this hour. Also, we'll take a look at the many choke slams of the Giant.
Yeah.
That very move that won him the World Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, what an arsenal he has. And I guarantee you, he's on top of the world right now. The most coveted title in all of sports, the World Heavyweight title, WCW. Pez Welly got out of that thing. I like it. Pez doing real well today.
Well, he got out, but he's not moving away quick enough. Wall Street right back. Oh, he blocked it.
Whoa. Yes.
A headbutt there by Wadley that rocks BK Wall Street. A second one.
Dance on him, Pez. Dance on him, baby.
Wall Street to team up with Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Ooh.
The Lethal Lottery to take on Regal and the Belfast Bruiser, unless the Bruiser can't make it. Unless that parking lot brawl was just too brutal. Look at that from Wadley. Wow.
He went to the well right there, made a big mistake. Now let's see if VK Wall Street can capitalize on this situation. Hung him up.
He caught him right underneath the chin. Wadley went down like a sack of bricks.
That's one, two, and three.
That's it.
He's got it.
He got him. One mistake cost him the match.
One mistake, too many. Not a smart thing to do against a man like Wall Street. Of course, I was saying that earlier. Dusty was dancing around in here.
Fulminating. We're going to take a look at the homeless DDT.
Fulminating at the mouth.
In a moment, but let's take a look at this again, Larry.
Well, right here, Wadley just didn't have the mental capacity here to deal with the consummate pro, Mr. Wall Street, who hooked him right underneath the chin. That knocked the wind out of Pistol Pez and scored a victory from Mr. Wall Street.
Now we take a look at the rapidly failing, falling fortunes of the now homeless DDP.
Oh, he just needs a break.
Frank Machuga here. Thank you very much for the hat. I've got some more footage for you, pulled it together. It's definitely Diamond Dallas this time. This guy apparently will do anything to hustle a buck except earn it. Take a look.
Look at him. What's that?
Yeah, man.
A cigar butt.
Oh. No way!
He put it in his mouth.
Yeah, perfect color. Hey, yeah. Okay. This guy cleaning windows in the rain.
I'm going to set you guys up right, man.
Okay.
I'm going to set you up right, man. I'm going to make this look really good.
Cleaning windows in the rain.
Look like that wrestler guy.
Who?
Who?
Hey, man, don't be playing around, man.
Diamond, who?
I'm gonna set you up right here.
No way, man.
Okay, baby.
No way.
That'd be $5, man.
$5? Are you crazy?
Crazy? I said $5.
$5?
Give me $5.
Yo. Oh, it is him.
Give me $5.
Give him 20. Here, take
20.
It.
Oh,
man, he's crazy.
Nice.
This man is crazy.
I really appreciate your hospitality.
Man, he didn't even do my window good. It took my $20.
What a low life.
Getting physical, man.
Hey, there's a cop here.
Here they come.
Oh, they got him now.
I saw him do this several times throughout the course of the day. Last time I saw him, he was heading down an alley. I'll try and catch up with him. See you then.
We show you now the Giant's arsenal. Well, that is an indication of why the Giant now wears the 10 pounds of gold. The massive Giant just choke-slamming everyone in sight, including the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Well, it's an awesome display of power by the Giant and the newly crowned World Heavyweight Champion at WCW with the Big Boy Flair. And I'll tell you something, Larry, this guy is going to be hard to beat. Lex Luger, total package tonight on WCW Saturday night. Take a hard, cold look at seeing where he's at against this guy, I guarantee you.
Well, also, I think the big factor tonight is to see where Jimmy Hart is going to be at. Definitely the Giant, the new heavyweight champion of the world. Never get around this guy and make that statement. I'm going to stick my neck out.
Scott Norton and Ice Train comprising the team of Fire and Ice. Tag team action this morning here on WCW Pro. Hey, fans, write this down a week from today. Next Saturday, the 11th of May, WCW live at the Freedom Hall in Johnson City, Tennessee. A week from tomorrow, that's the 12th of May, live in Knoxville, Tennessee. And really, 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 really live next Monday night. A week from this Monday, the 13th of May, for WCW's Monday Nitro, live in Nashville.
I tell you what, these two guys here possess so much power. I'm talking about Fire and Ice, great team, put themselves together out of respect. And I guarantee you, they are powerful and a team to be reckoned with. You just mentioned Nitro. This Monday Nitro coming up, special start time, 7 p.m. Right or wrong, yes and nay, yeah and nay, right or wrong.
Yes.
All right.
That's
a
yay.
Bottom line, we talked about all the situations that have been chronologically put down about the Macho Man Randy Savage, but my friend, he will be at Nitro against Hugh Morris, brother, cuffed or not. Look for him to come out firing.
You know, Macho Man, that emotionally unstable state of mind he is, I got some advice for him. Forget all about the past with Miss Elizabeth. I think we should fix him up with Margot Kidder.
Well, whatever it is, Nitro this Monday night, the man will be there, Sting and Regal. And let me tell you something real quickly about these guys right here. I'm talking about these two guys. Now, when you take a look at Harlem Heat, you take a look at Lugenstein, and you take a look at the American Males, you take a look at Steiners and the Warriors. These guys right here, powerfully, I'm talking about Fine Ice, Larry, match up with them guys power-wise, I believe, evenly.
But these guys definitely got power to
and
spare.
And enemy, too.
You could probably put Fire and Ice together, and after a wrestling match, still have enough electromagnetism left in them to light the entire city of Los Angeles.
Ooh. Also, this coming Monday night on Nitro, that 7 p.m. special start time on WCW Monday Nitro on TNT, as Ice Train at 320 pounds rams into the Southern Posse. It's Dean Malenko against Jushin Thunder Liger.
Wow.
As you said, Macho Man takes on Hugh Morris, and Stinger against Lord Steven Regal as Sting heads towards Battle Bowl to lead the lottery in his shot at the newly crowned heavyweight champion of the world, the Giant. Unless, of course, Lex Luger beats the Giant tonight.
You guys are taking for granted that Sting's going to have an easy time with Lord Regal. Nothing Lord Regal would love to do more than to get rid of Sting on Nitro, and maybe he move up.
It's a very good point, and a chop there from Norton.
Yeah, what a move right there. Great power slam by him. Caught him real good. Takes his time. I'm talking about Scotty Norton. Takes his time. Really analyzes the situation. Got a tag to the young man they call Ice Train right here. And I think they're getting ready to either uncle him or try to put him away. I'm talking about the Southern Posse. But Southern Posse got other ideas, look like.
As this team of Fire and Ice has really gelled. And look at the power from Ice Train.
Well, that was definitely a bad idea by the Southern Posse. Don't throw your body into a man that size, that strong. Caught him in midair and just dumped him. Hag Scott Norton. And this guy is big and mean.
Some real exciting news this hour of WCW Pro as World Championship Wrestling heads to the Northeastern United States.
They got him over there. Oh, look, clubbing.
Yes, they did clubbing.
The Southern Posse are clubbing on the pro show this morning. Unbelievable. Could turn the tide. Whoop.
Scott Norton broke through that. He came up with another clothesline.
That's like putting a roadblock up, and you got one of them Hummers, and just ride right through that thing. I ain't lying. That's how big it is. Hummers, big car. Truck.
All the military
vehicles. It's more like a Jeep thing.
Oh. Always wear your seatbelt in a Hummer. As Ice Train now clobbering, just clobbering the Southern Posse. Well, that's what I heard anyway. Back. Nice suplex there by Ice Train.
You should always wear your seatbelt when you're wrestling Ice Train and Scott Norton. These guys will just throw you out of anything. Boy, it's a big, powerful man.
Scott Norton got him up. Now then,
before the shoulder breaker.
Yeah, man, and that'll really crack you up right there. And I'm not talking about in a joyful way either.
Scott Norton and Ice Train. He must have got a 5 or 6 feet of vertical leap, and they have defeated the Southern Posse.
Look out, tag team, here they come. I'm talking about Fire and Ice, Norton and the Ice Train.
And they, in fact, are together as a team at Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery. They're going to face Stevie Ray and Big Bubba Rogers. So the team of Fire and Ice may be favored going into Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery. This replay brought to you by Skittles. Taste the rainbow of fruit flavor.
Boy, Norton just busted through the Southern Posse's double lariat, came back with a 360 of his own, nailed this guy flat, tagged the Ice Train. This guy must have springs in his shoes. He just flies up there, and on the way down, you must have a megaton, brother.
We talked about Fire and Ice together as a team against Stevie Ray and Big Bubba Rogers. We'll see Big Bubba and a lot more when we continue in a moment on The Pro. Good morning, folks. We're going to get you back to Cruz, the legend and the dream here on The Pro in just a moment or two. Attention, hotline fans. The 7 foot, 4 inch, 468 pound giant was just crowned the WCW heavyweight champ, and already there's a rumor circulating that the big man may be leaving professional wrestling altogether. Who's he been talking to? Where could he be going? I've talked to the individuals involved and actually seen firsthand the correspondence that was exchanged. Because of the sensitive nature of this subject matter, it's something we can't talk about on the air, but I will talk about today on the hotline. Give me a call right now at 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900. Call now. Hey, we're back to action here on WCW Pro. Cruz, the dream, and the legend, the gentleman. At the conclusion of this match, we're going to hear from Mean Gene Okerlund, see if he can verify speculation that indeed the Belfast Bruiser is going to be unable to be a participant in Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery. So, it looks like, if indeed that is the case, Lord Steven Regal is going to need a new partner.
Well, here's one of the guys that are in the lethal lottery. I'm talking about Big Bubba. And I guarantee you one thing, anytime, any place, anywhere, he stands to get a victory. I'm telling you, that's how powerful and big he is. Talking about WCW Monday Nitro Live, 7 p.m. this Monday night. Sting and Regal talking about him and just what he come off of. And most of all, very anxious to see the mode or the mood, if you will, of the Macho Man Randy Savage. After all that has happened to him, going to see him at Monday Nitro. Humaz and pound for pound, they say it. Malenko great, the Juice and Thunder Liger. What a treat it will to see him on Monday Nitro this Monday on TNT.
And Big Bubba is going to be teaming up indeed with Stevie Ray to take on the team we saw earlier this hour. In fact, this previous match, the team of Fire and Ice. That team, as well as the Public Enemy, clearly have to be considered the favorites going into Slammery, the Lethal Lottery. Look at that from Big Power Pack Leroy Howard.
Yeah. You know, I like the Public Enemy in this situation. I think they lucked out with the drawing of the lottery. You've got a team intact, and their whole aura is perfect for that type of competition.
Hey, wait a minute. Leroy Howard got something going here.
He sure does.
Leroy
Howard got something.
Yeah.
Big Bubba.
I'm telling you, went to the well twice on him and bounced off a Leroy Howard. And Bubba going to try to rough him up right here. But Leroy, I mean, he understands now. Hey, I can take his best shot.
Oh.
Except when I get a thumb in the eye. See. And then I can't see real well.
Yeah, Leroy a big guy, but boy, he left his face wide open. Big Bubba, this guy's huge, moves like a lightweight throwing.
Who is that?
Big Bubba.
Oh, I thought you were talking about
Leroy. We are told that the switch...
And that's... Forget the switchboard. That's what Big Bubba takes advantage of a lot of guys is when you see how big he is, you don't realize he can reach out and tag you as quick. He walked into an elbow by Leroy.
There you go.
Well, we are told that the switchboard is lighting up. The fans want to know when and where WCW is coming to the Northeast. And I've got the details right here. But first, wait a minute. Let's see what Leroy Howell...
Oh, look at that.
Beautiful move, the unknown Leroy Howard is taking it to Big Bubba. Let's stay with the action here. Beautiful standing drop kick, and Bubba says, I am leaving.
Well, all Bubba's right. Going to regroup right. Hey, Leroy, not letting him.
Oh!
Don't tell me about the switchboard now. Leroy is in trouble.
Holy smokes.
Yeah, Leroy left.
I think Leroy's going to need a board without the switch on it.
All yeah. Right, real quickly. All tickets right. Going to go on sale Friday, May 24th for the following. Hold on, there's more action here. It's nonstop for the following locations.
And
Friday,
they are.
June 28th in Hartford at the Civic Center.
Whoa.
Saturday, June 29th in Philadelphia at the Civic Center. And Sunday, June 30th in New York at the Paramount Theater at Madison Square Garden.
Where the big boys play are coming to your town. See it live.
Tickets on sale Friday, May 24th for those three
venues.
And look at this, the swing neck breaker. This could be it. Just keep in mind, Leroy already landed on his head.
Yeah, but Leroy, I tell you what, Leroy has looked real well in this matchup right here. And Bubba didn't have an easy task, and I guarantee you, he still ain't been able to put Leroy Howard away.
Well, I think the overzealous actions of Leroy, he went flying over that rope trying to get Bubba, but Bubba just sidestepped him. Leroy bounced off that cement floor, and I don't care who you are, you're not going to recover from that.
A headbutt at a very wobbly Leroy Howard now. Wait on wobbly.
Bubba knocked himself out.
You know, it's amazing that Leroy Howard is even standing after what happened outside the ring, let alone.
Well, he's a firing back right now, Chris.
With some offense, indeed he is. Look at this. Oh!
Ooh, caught him.
Larry.
I mean, literally caught him.
Yeah, that rocked those semicircular canals right there, and Bubba. The aggressive big man that he is still moving like a lightweight, slapping Leroy in the face. And Leroy, he can't do a thing about it now.
A reverse chin lock. I think, gentlemen, you'd probably agree. This is one of the hardest fought matches we've seen Big Bubba Rogers in a long time. And that includes any other wrestler he's faced, let alone this, as we said, relatively unknown Leroy Howard. This could be the match that makes Leroy Howard's career.
Or ends it.
A very good point. Now the whip to the far rope. Big Bubba! Oh, the scoop slam.
Turn out the light. The party's over, baby.
Indeed it is. A tremendous showing, however, for Leroy Howard. But that man, Big Bubba Rogers, at 6'5", at 320 pounds, so physically dominant, he's not even blinking.
I want to see the replay where Leroy bounces off the cement.
Well, I'm not sure if we're going to show you exact. Well, who knows? Maybe the truck will decide that that's what we need
and
to see.
And he did. Look at there he goes. Leroy. The leap of faith. Big Bubba moved. Leroy. He bounced off the steps and the cement. Right there. Bubba caught him with that elbow underneath the chin. And So much for Leroy.
Oh, a lot more to come here on the Pro. We'll take you back to Nitro to see how the Giant defeated Ric Flair. All that in a moment. Hi again, everyone. Here we go again, back in the control center, counting down to Slamboree, just 2 weeks from this Sunday evening, live from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and available only on pay-per-view. Call your cable company now to get the hookup. This year's Lethal Lottery has blown a lot of folks away. 32 men, I mean, count them, 32 men, 16 tag teams in all, squaring off against each other, with the final four teams split into eight individuals for the romp in Battle Bowl. That's the battle royal that'll determine the Lord of the Ring. Then that man, the winner, will ultimately get a shot at the WCW Heavyweight Champion during the Great American Bash this summer, this June to be specific, in Baltimore, Maryland. Now, the pairings have been strange indeed. I mean, you talk about friend against friend, foe versus foe. What about foe and foe as partners? Remember now, these men want to make it to Battle Bowl. Can bitter enemies like Ric Flair and Randy Savage coexist? I mean, we're talking about the Nature Boy and the Macho Man. Can they coexist against the likes of Arn Anderson and Eddie Guerrero? What about the Road Warriors? They're going to be on opposing teams. So will Scott and Rick Steiner. Here's a couple of brothers. Lord Steven Regal was to team up with the Belfast Bruiser, but you know what? He knocked him out on that parking lot fiasco this past week. Lord Steven Regal now to team with his good friend, Squire David Taylor. Plus, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, the one-on-one meeting between the new WCW Heavyweight Champion, and I do mean heavyweight, 7 foot 4 inch, 468 pounds of the Giant. He's going to be challenged by Sting. It all happens 2 weeks from this Sunday, May the 19th at 7 o'clock Eastern. Call your cable company, satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier or DirecTV. Don't miss Slamboree. Cruz, the dream, and the legend, and gentlemen, we're about to see the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, in action, the former heavyweight champion of the world against Hacksaw Jim Duggan. But before we go to that match, Dusty, let's take the fans back to this past WCW Monday Nitro, when the Giant convincingly became the heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, at home, you want to tape this thing. Get your tape machine all ready, because history has been made. The passing of the torch, if you will. A new world's heavyweight champion, most prestigious title in the world, and the Giant now really becomes the biggest boy of what a big boy player at WCW.
Indeed, and a marked man, and in fact, he has got a real challenge ahead of him, the Giant does, at Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery, Larry.
Well, Sting has an opportunity of a lifetime to prove to everybody worldwide exactly what he's made of. Personally, boys, I think Sting's going to be carried out on a stretcher.
We're going to find out live and only on pay-per-view May 19th. We take you now back to Nitro. Ric Flair, since that defeat in the hands of the Giant.
Well, if you thought Ric Flair proclaimed himself to be the dirtiest player in the game before, I bet you all the money I have, and that's quite a substantial amount, Ric Flair will become the dirtiest player ever than he ever was before. Of course, he's in there with a mental giant, ho-hum, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. You know, scientifically speaking, what? The human brain is 80% water.
Yeah.
Hacksaw had a CAT scan. All they found inside his cranium was the entire Sahara Desert.
Oh, stop it. Hacksaw Jim Duggan teaming up with VK Wall Street at Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery, to take on Lord Steven Regal. And now, of course, as we know, Squire David Taylor, the career of the Belfast Bruiser, may be over after what we saw at that parking lot brawl.
Well, it was brutal on his past Nitro, and this Nitro coming up this Monday at 7 p.m. ain't gonna be no different. And I guarantee you one thing, Sting and Regal are gonna get it on. Macho Man, though, is the thing that I am really concerned about, because I understand where he's at. He's got to clear his mind about this situation. And the Giant, the world's heavyweight champion, Luger on Saturday night, tonight, world's title, big events at WCW. But Nature Boy has a great ability, guys, to rebound from situations like this. I know for a fact, on three occasions, he rebounded like this.
Showing why he may be the greatest champion of them all.
Well,
we're back with this match in a moment.
The legend, and gentlemen, our first look at the Nature Boy after he lost that World Heavyweight Championship to the Giant.
Well, what an interesting situation coming up at Slamboree. Ric Flair, Nature Boy, picked to be on the same team. Neither of these men may be in an emotional, controllable state. I still think, however, Ric Flair has a lot more to gain by keeping his cool, to get another shot, to become Lord of the Ring, to get his hands back on the Giant or whoever the champion may be. On the other hand, Macho Man completely off his rocker.
And I tell you what, if you're going to beat Danger Boy Ric Flair coming off a thing like he's just been through, an emotional weekend, if you will, right now is the time. Big Hacksaw Jim Duggan got to go ahead and turn it on. Speaking of the Macho Man Randy Savage, I think this Monday night on Nitro, WCW's TNT Monday Nitro, we'll get a maybe a closer look as we get closer.
Hey,
wait, she's leaving again. Get a closer look at the Macho Man Randy Savage.
This is so
every time.
Weird.
Yeah, it's like she's calling somebody. Elizabeth, there's conversations going on in the back right there. That'd throw you off.
Maybe she wants to keep Elizabeth out of there. Every time Elizabeth's in there, Macho Man cannot be controlled.
Well, you know, he might be in this building somewhere hiding right now.
Tonight on WCW Saturday Night, the Barbarian against the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit. What a huge challenge that is for Benoit. Alex Wright in action. The Steiner Brothers. This woman comes back. A real mystery. And for the World Heavyweight Championship, the Giant takes on Lex Luger. Does that mean if Lex Luger defeats the Giant tonight on WCW Saturday Night, that it's Lex Luger against Sting for the championship at Slamboree?
Of course it does.
At Lethal Lottery?
Of course it does.
Wow.
And, as Larry said, how does Jimmy Hart, the Snake of the Grass, come into play right here? You see Nature Boy Ric Flair now really not getting in a hurry, Larry, with this big guy. I'm talking about Hacksaw Jim Duggan, because he know Duggan can hurt him, and he's done been in there with one big guy that put hurting on him.
Yeah, well, Ric Flair might have had a moment of weakness, but look at right here. He definitely is a master of human chess, and it doesn't take much of an IQ to outwit Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, I tell you what, you got that devilish woman out there, too. That devilish woman. What'd you say, Hacksaw? What? How you say that? Jim, what?
Well, I don't want to say it again.
How you say
it? You'll steal it.
No, let's hear it. Say it again.
I'm not saying it again.
Oh, Larry. In the course of broadcast journalism, sometimes you got to repeat yourself.
Who do you think I am, Steve McMichaels?
Uh-oh. And Flair is up, and what will Duggan do with him? Duggan, nearly 300 pounds, Duggan's actually lost some weight recently.
Whoa. Oh.
Got him in the eye. Both of them fell down.
Oh!
Hey! She didn't nail him. I'm going to tell you what. Nobody's as devilish as that devilish woman is. I mean, they named her right. Woman. Devilish woman.
Did they name her devilish woman?
I did.
Oh, you did.
And well, I repeated it twice.
Here comes the figure four.
He's got Hacksaw in trouble here. Hacksaw right in the middle of the ring.
Yeah, but Hacksaw's in trouble from the blow he took outside.
Hacksaw's in trouble when he wakes up in the morning.
Come on, Hacksaw, get it up, baby.
All right, I guess we've agreed that Hacksaw Jim Duggan is in trouble in varying degrees at varying times.
Here you go.
And if Duggan can turn this over, it's even more painful.
Oh, yeah, too big a leg, too powerful. Turn it over. Nature Boy really hurting now on the hurting side of a figure four leg lock.
And Duggan up surprisingly quickly and laying in those rights and lefts.
Yeah, Flair's got to get out of that corner.
He is.
Oh, yeah, he's out now. Oh, and he flops. Face first and tries to get right back up. Makes it to his knees. Now back up on both feet. And suckers Jim Duggan.
Yeah, he did.
Well, that's not hard to do. Problem is hurting Duggan physically. You know, massive man, Neanderthalic human being. Flair's definitely going about this the right way. He's got to outsmart him mentally, but he took too long getting up there.
They sure did, and Duggan again showing surprising
speed. All right,
speed.
He got him. Here
They're
we go.
More than halfway across the ring now.
Here we
what
go.
What can the Hacksaw do? Here it is, the spear. Oh,
cover him, Duggan.
He's got to get him. He's got... Hey, he goes after a woman. Bad well, mistake.
She was coming to nail him. Get got from behind.
He rolls him up and grabs the tights, and Flair also uses the ropes. That's the three count.
Checkmate.
Well, I'll tell you what, Ninja Boy Ric Flair looking to get out of that thing with his hide. Once again, proving he's the dirtiest player in the game. That was dirty. Using the ropes, using her, using woman. Devilish.
I think it was more clever than anything. I mean, otherwise you're going to take a heck of a pounding with Hacksaw Duggan's, you know, fists and stuff. Look at this.
Yeah, look at that. What is that? Is that his fist?
A little help from your friends.
Oh, man, Larry, I tell you, sometime you blind me. You blind me.
Right there, Ric Flair blinded Hacksaw Jim Duggan with mentality. little extra leverage right there. And of course, the dirtiest player in the game wants nothing more than to get his hands on that gold. Time will tell the saga of the Nature Boy.
Well, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, begins his climb back up the ladder as he attempts at some point in history to become the 14th time heavyweight champion of the world. But as we all know, for now, it is the giant wearing the 10 pounds of gold. Larry, tonight on WCW Saturday Night, the Steiner Brothers in action. But of course, at Slamboree, the Steiner Brothers are going to face off against one another in that tag team attraction.
Yeah, interesting scenario. A lot of intrigue. Will it work against them or for them? You know, there may be an opportunity in that match where one Steiner brother will do something to protect the other Steiner brother, because even if one Steiner brother becomes Lord of the Ring, both Steiner brothers will be the victors.
Absolutely. We're all looking forward to that live and only on pay-per-view May 19th. And Dusty, tonight we're looking forward to seeing the Giant take on Lex Luger.
Well, once again, that was a great analogy by the legendary Lance Bisco, my colleague, if you will. So true about the Steiner brothers. Taking a hard, cold look at WCW Saturday Night, the mothership, me and Tony Schiavone, the silver tongue, if you will, Tony Schiavone, taking a real great match tonight. We talking Luger and the Giant, his first title defense on television, if you will. It's on Saturday night. You don't want to miss it, because I wonder if Jimmy Hart, that stinking of the grass, got some going in this situation with Luger and the Giant tonight on Saturday night.
Indeed, we're going to find out 6.05 p.m. Eastern right here on TBS. I'm Cruz for the Dream of the Legend. We'll see you tonight on Saturday night. Studios in Orlando, Florida. It's WCW Pro on TBS. Hi, everyone, and welcome. I cruise along with the living legend Larry Zbyszko and the American dream Dusty Rhodes. Lex Luger, as we saw from Nitro, late again. Larry, the question is, what's it going to take for Lex Luger to be on time for his matches with the Giant?
You know, you sound like one of these whining weekend wrestlers that think they know what they're doing. Don't criticize Lex Luger. Here's a man of integrity. He is going out of his way to make sure he camps out specifically to be there to prove to everybody he's not afraid of the Giant. And in terms of everybody's quest to figure out the true power source, always follow the gold. And in WCW, the gold seems to be following Jimmy Hart.
Lex Luger ought to follow somebody to a watch shop and make sure he's there on time. Dusty, today, here on the Pro, the main event, a rematch featuring the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Dirty Dick Slater.
Well, quickly, I address the situation with Lex Luger. I got my own opinions about it. I'm going to talk about it this morning, and I don't believe that he really brought out what it's all about, but I am doing the program. But once again, Dick Slater, who dominated the last confrontation with the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, gets another shot right here this morning on the Pro.
And now we take you to the ring. It's the American Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, Marcus Bagwell and Scotty Briggs, the American Males.
And what a way to begin the Saturday morning here on TBS on the Pro. And hey, a new look for the American Males. Isn't that interesting?
But they do get Bagwell. They go to plastic surgeons.
I tell you what, we started off to a bang here on Saturday morning, WCW Pro. American Males getting ready to do it. Bottom line, guys, it's right around the corner. Sunday is Mother's Day. Say hello to my mom out in Houston, Texas. Hello, Mom, and happy Mother's Day.
And of course, a week from Sunday, it is Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery.
Their opponents first from Tokyo, Japan, Pat Tanaka. His partner from Newport, Richie, Florida, Ned Brady.
Pat Tanaka from Tokyo, Japan, brings to mind the new cruiserweight champion by the name of Otani. And Otani will defend that title for the first time. It's against Dean Malenko next weekend on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Check your local listings for time and station.
And that'd be a great match for all the people into that game of human chess to tune in. Malenko, man of a thousand holds. Otani, excellent mat technician and wrestler. That's going to be a good one.
As we begin this morning with tag team wrestling, Dusty, we're reminded that tonight on WCW Saturday Night, another tag team, Fire and Ice, take on the Steiner Brothers. Fire and Ice to be at the Lethal Lottery together, Public Enemy together, but the Steiner Brothers on opposite sides.
Yeah, we are really rolling towards Slammery, the big pay-per-view. And the audience will get a hardcore look, if you will, of a picture of the brothers standing together, maybe for the last time before they go to Slamboree, to where they'll be on opposite sides trying to make it on to Love and the Ring. And you see Pat Tanaka right here dealing. Well, he was dealing.
He was, but Scotty Riggs showing he can fight fire with fire. And look at this from Riggs. Line cross body block could do it. No, a two count. And Tanaka, oh, deep arm drag. Also coming up in Nashville, Tennessee.
Whoa.
This Monday night. Live on Nitro on TNT, that special start time, 7 p.m. Eastern. It is Public Enemy against the Steiners. A whole lot more to tell you about this hour as Bagwell and Riggs. Beautiful move there.
Well, double team, nice utilization of teamwork. Tanaka barely kicked out of this situation.
What? What's wrong with your head?
Nothing's wrong with my head. Do I got the cheap headsets?
No, you're fine. They gave you the right headset.
Nasty Ned Brady in for the first time, showing why he is named that. Rake of the eyes there, Bagwell, and those thundering blows there to the back of the neck of Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Reversal now, and Bagwell is dropped.
Nasty Ned dropped Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Bagwell with a leap, using that speed. But Nasty Ned caught him in the belly willy.
Bagwell left an opening. Ned took advantage. Nice reversal. He even kicked out that leg, and Bagwell nailed him in the face.
Well, of course he got him in the face.
Nasty Ned may need the plastic surgeon.
No, Nasty Ned loves being ugly.
How about?
He loves being ugly.
I was going to get you an appointment, nasty, but it wouldn't
be
any good.
To be nasty, what? To be nasty, you got to be ugly.
Well, it works for the nasty boys.
I don't know why people insist on being ugly. You know, it takes 43 muscles to frown and only 17 to smile.
Oh, stop it.
You'd think that people would want to smile more. It takes fewer muscles.
It only takes one shot in the face to erase all those muscles.
I'll tell you somebody that ain't smiling, the Macho Man Randy Savage, once again this past Nitro. I mean, brother, there were people had to take him out of the building, escort him away from that situation. And you talk about Slamboree, Flair, Macho Man on the same team. I guarantee you, each week that goes by, each live Nitro that happens on Monday night, I expect to see these guys battling it out before they get there.
Hey, right here, Scotty Riggs got distracted by Tanaka. He looked around too long. Nasty Ned, he pounced on this guy.
Ned thinks he's got hold of a bowling ball there. And now he grabs the ears and Tanaka goes in. For the kill there. Look at this. He pulls the hair of Scotty Riggs, and Riggs now holding his throat. Oh. Headbutt, and Riggs in the wrong corner.
Yeah, at the wrong time. Right there. Tanaka, sneaky guy, very quick, master of martial arts. And right there, just leveled one right underneath the throat. You can see Riggs sucking forever. He reversed it.
Tanaka goes up, and Riggs. Oh, he's caught. He's in as much trouble as March. Shot one. Almost a two count there. And Lawrence Taylor, for that matter. Bagwell comes in and tries to rescue his partner. He doesn't need it, but he does now. And Ned is backed up. Riggs has tagged Bagwell. The referee's backwards turned. Is he going to allow it?
Hey, no. He's pushing Bagwell out. He didn't see the tag, but that was a good maneuver on the part of Nasty Ned. Take advantage of referee being out of position.
What an upset this would be on WCW Pro this morning. If Nasty Ned and Tanaka took a victory over the American Mills, anything can happen at WCW with the big boys playing.
And the big boys are playing tonight in Johnson City, WCW live tonight, whoa, tomorrow night in Knoxville, and Monday, of course, in tomorrow afternoon in Knoxville, and Monday in Nashville for live Monday Nitro. Nasty Ned and Pat Tanaka looking great here against the American Males.
Yeah, I think Rick should have made the tag. Instead, he tried to fight back. Telegram, you know, he sent right there to Nasty Ned. Kicked him in the face. Oh, he nailed Tanaka.
Tanaka tried to turn away, but Riggs still got him. Now the question is, can he tag Bagwell?
Well, he needs to get over, get a fresh man in there. We talk about it so much, but very important. That's the end. Can he tag Marcus Bagwell? Here you go, Christopher.
Indeed, Bagwell with a right. Another one. Tanaka's down. Ned's down. He's back up. Back down. They're both back down. And look at this scoop slam with authority. He slams him into the mat. And a beautiful clothesline.
What a clothesline. That was a 360, boys.
Indeed it was. A fisherman suplex. And Bagwell hooks the leg. But unfortunately, Tanaka there on a wide open Marcus Alexander Bagwell. All four men in the ring now, as we can plainly see. And Nasty Ned And Pat Tanaka getting the worst of it. They're slammed into each other.
There's four guys. The Bagwell, he's a legal man. And it was over the top rope there.
Yes, it was. A double drop kick. That's going to do it.
Well, you can turn out the light. The party's over right here. The Mac and Mill going to get a victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the American Mill.
Great tag team action like we're going to see tonight on WCW Saturday night. And Fire and Ice take on the Steiner Brothers. Also, Sting against BK Wall Street and Earl Robert Eaton against Eddie Guerrero. That's tonight on WCW Saturday night. Also tonight, live WCW action in Johnson City, Tennessee. Let's see that again, gentlemen, in our slow-motion instant replay. It's brought to you by Pep Boys. It's our power pin of the week.
Right there, Nasty Ned. Nice reversal by Bagwell. Right here, drop kicks Ned right smack in the face. Goes up, gets him again. American Males, they were on a roll today. Had the momentum, caught Pat Tanaka even off guard. And that's not always an easy thing to do. Utilize their teamwork. Made a lot of tags, but at the end here, just gave this boy the double team razzle dazzle.
Our Pet Boys Power Pin of the Week. We're back with more action, including some excerpts from Monday Nitro. Don't go away. We're back in a moment. Monday Nitro on TNT as Lex Luger was late again for his title shot against the Giant. We're back to action here on WCW Pro Cruise along with the living legend Larry Zbysko. And where is Dusty Rhodes? Where has the American Dream gone?
He's right here.
Oh, you're back.
Yes.
Where you been?
I've been getting some news from the back, talking to American Male, getting ready for the Saturday night tonight. Silver Tongue, Tony Schiavone. We got so much going on WCW Saturday night with a big boss play. And a lot left here on the Pro Show this morning, talking Nitro and another deal about Diamond Dallas, man, down on his luck.
That's right.
And I also was back there. I was taking a bath in milk.
You were what?
Taking a bath in milk.
Where'd they find that much milk?
That is dangerous. You sure that milk was pasteurized?
No, it was up to my neck.
You had to ask him, didn't you?
I always do that for Mother's Day. That was for my mom out in Houston, a little present right here on the Pro Show.
Did your mom should take a bath?
No, in milk.
A present?
Drink her milk.
Talk about one of the biggest boys in WCW, one-man gang right there. Just towering over his opponent here, Rick Garcia.
Speaking of somebody who...
I don't even think he's looking at the guy yet.
Speaking of somebody who towers, it's Shaquille O'Neal. He, along with our own Hulk Hogan and Sugar Ray Leonard at a charity event, will have exclusive video tonight on WCW Saturday night.
Another thing it was, Hulkamania running rampant around WCW and around the world. Once again, good deeds done by the man himself, the immortal Hulk Hogan. Going to take a hardcore look at it tonight on WCW Saturday night.
One-man gang rocked now by Rick Garcia, who looks great against this man, the former U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
He got him wobbly.
And the one-man gang, so impressive as a big man, but Garcia, virtually unknown, looking really good this morning here on the Pro.
Well, his last few outings, I'm talking about Garcia, he has looked very good. Might get him.
He gets the gang over and gets a two count on the man.
Has looked good.
Oh, that was a good shot in the mouth.
Also, a look at the new cruiserweight champion tonight in WCW Saturday night. And look at this, pull of the hair, and he's just slamming the one-man gang, and he chops him. Yeah, who is this kid Garcia?
I don't think one-man gang was ready in the beginning. He reversed it there. Hey, Garcia moved.
Gotta he rolls him up. He's got one, two, and what an upset this will be. Garcia gets some momentum. And, oh!
Well, he ran right into a strong arm of the law, if you will. I'm talking about one-man gang in public, put him down. Garcia, as I said earlier, now once again, has looked good in his last few outings.
Looked good?
Yeah.
That was one mistake too many, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Just a few moments.
And that's another one.
A few moments ago, we saw some excerpts from Nitro. We'll see some more from Nitro a little bit later in this hour. And this Monday night, live as live can be, as Eric Bischoff says, from Nashville, Dusty, BK Wall Street against Ric Flair.
Well,
this Monday night.
That is so true. You just astonish me.
Public Enemy against the Steiners.
Yeah, and Luger be claiming that he's missed two. I know, right?
Oh,
two shots. Say, if I gotta camp out, I will. to make a shot to meet the Giant at WCW TNT Monday Nitro Live this Monday, 7 p.m. Eastern. Don't miss it.
Hey, Garcia just gave One Man Gang a couple of shots. There's another one right there. But don't get on Luger's case too much.
Oh, what are you talking about?
He was playing a charity golf tournament for little kids.
That's going to do it. A great showing there from Rick Garcia. But the One Man Gang gets it done where the big boys play. Right here, we get it done after all. If we don't do it, who will?
Well, let me ask a question, though, before we get in there. I know the slow-mo coming. Let me ask you a question, legendary Larry Zbysko, my esteemed colleague. Are you telling me that Lex Luger is not tied in with Jimmy Hart? Is that what you're telling me?
No, what I told you was Lex Luger had a prior engagement at a celebrity golf tournament. I know. I was the main invitee, celebrity player there.
Yeah, the 747.
In fact, I won the longest drive.
Yeah, 747.
Believe me, he was there.
747 splash.
You came from furthest away?
No. Why don't you get the bath ready for Dusty?
I can't believe you.
Now we take you to Frank Machuga for a look at Diamond Dallas Page.
Hey, Diamond Dallas, all the man needs is a break.
Hello, Frank Machuga here. I learned from the people of the streets that they're creatures of habit. In fact, I caught up earlier this week with Diamond Dallas Page in the exact same spot I first met up with him, trying to hustle a buck. The last part of this video can only be described as intriguing.
I know he's made $150 sitting on that corner tonight.
Please. People think you're helping out somebody's debt for him, and you got a scumball like that taking off his money. That's huge. A lot of money out of that one, man. Check it out, man. He's getting in.
No way. Who let him in?
Let's go. Come on, let's go.
Catch up with him. Come on, let's go. Get him.
What's the license plate number? Did you see who's in there?
Who's in there?
Was it a guy or a girl? I didn't see anybody in the backseat, Harley, too.
Oh, man.
That video was shot earlier this week. We tried to chase down the limo or get a license plate number, but were unsuccessful. I haven't seen Diamond Dallas in the past 3 days. He's not frequenting his usual haunts. I don't know where he is, but if I get some more footage, I'll be back in touch.
Of course, Mother's Day, don't you dare forget that, but don't you dare forget as well, as we just heard in the Slamboree Control Center a week from tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view, it is Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery, the Lord of the Ring, is to be named, and he will get a shot at the World Heavyweight Champion at the Great American Bash, and of course,
Dusty always knows everything, somehow. Who was in the limousine with Diamond Dallas Page now? I want to know what's going on. I always liked the ability of Diamond Dallas. The man just needs a break. What's going on here, old dream?
I tell you what, it was a simple twist of fate, if you know what I'm talking about.
No.
Dallas, something happened. Well, somebody seemed to have reached out and pulled him in. And Dallas down on his luck. The question is, who is the benefactor, if you will, that pulled him into the limo? Matchup time, two big boots, a lot of muscle. I'm going right on by you, Zbysko.
You should
right
be a politician. And
right over here, right over here with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Go get it on the pro this morning. I don't know who it was, but I'm going to find out.
Hacksaw, of course, participating in Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery. Max Muscle, as tough and rough as he is, there's no match for a 2x4.
That's going to be interesting here. At least Hacksaw is in the ring with someone his own size and power. Let's see if Max Muscle approaches this right now. You don't want to get clubbed by Duggan. And Muscle definitely big enough to handle himself here against Hacksaw Jim Duggan. What a Neanderthal. Look at him.
I knew you were going to say that.
I can't help it.
What?
Calling how I see it.
Well, I tell you what, you said one thing that's true. These two guys are big and muscular, and there's no finesse in this thing, Christopher Crew. But I guarantee you one thing, Hacksaw Jim Duggan
I put this guy's lights out if he makes a mistake.
Max Muscle just did make that mistake, Dusty, indeed. And Hacksaw saying, hey-o, and he does. Oh, will Max Muscle go down? Apparently not. This man about 300 pounds. You're not going to get him down that way. But maybe this will do it, and indeed it does. After three clotheslines, Max Muscle down and out. Hey, World Championship Wrestling headed to the northeastern part of the United States. Friday, the 28th of June in Hartford, Connecticut. The 29th of June in Philadelphia at the Civic Center, and the 30th at the Paramount, Madison Square Gardens, Paramount in New York City. Tickets go on sale May 24th for all the excitement of WCW in the Northeast. And Duggan now slammed into the steel ring post.
Duggan hit the pole. He tried a couple moves on Max Muscle, but again, his lack of ability to concentrate always puts Duggan in predicaments when he's in there against guys his own size.
And I tell you what, opportunity knocking for Dick Slater, one of the toughest men in wrestling, right here on our main event today this morning on the Pro Show. I cannot wait for that. What action we got. What a weekend we got. Saturday night going on and getting ready for big WCW TNT Monday Night Raw Live this Monday night.
Indeed it is. BK Wall Street against Ric Flair. Ric Flair in our main event, Dusty, as you mentioned, against Dick Slater. Public Enemy takes on the Steiners, 7 p.m. Eastern on TNT. This Monday night, Squire David Taylor against Chris Benoit. And the main event, the world title on the line, the Giant defending against Lex Luger, maybe this time.
And Luger
Luger will show up on time.
He's going to camp out, he says.
He better.
So he don't miss it. I'm going to camp out.
He's a man of his word. He'll be there.
Somebody who was there last Monday at Nitro was the Macho Man Randy Savage, and it was this referee who got the worst of that confrontation. Took him almost a full week to recover.
Yeah, Savage got a heavy fine, but again, I don't think Macho Man cares. I think he is beyond all hope and reasonable ability to comprehend anything logical and within the realms of sanity, which means he's a worthless human vegetable as far as I'm concerned.
Pull of the hair there, and looks like Hacksaw Jim Duggan able to escape from that hold, but just barely. Max Muscle doing very well against the longtime popular wrestler Hacksaw Jim Duggan, who's backing up. Uh-oh, the whip, and Duggan goes into the turnbuckle, and so does Max Muscle.
Oh, Muscle, that wasn't very smart right there, and he nailed him.
He's going to do it. Duggan's going to get the 1-2-3, a victor here on WCW Pro on TBS this morning. We're back with a lot more action, including some news about tonight and Nitro in a moment here on TBS.
About two major WWF players rumored to be headed here to World Championship Wrestling. Irrespective of what you might have heard this past week on the internet, I believe it was on America Online, irrespective of what you might have heard, we've got the very latest on this alleged movement of these two individuals. Will they be coming to World Championship Wrestling, or will they stay put? I'm going to have that story. Plus, of course, we're going to be covering all the inside turmoil, the behind-the-scenes chaos, if you will, leading us into Slamboree. All that today during my exclusive hotline report, 1-900-909-9900. 1-900-909-9900. Call now.
We're back to action here on WCW Pro on TBS on a Mother's Day weekend. Cruise along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. A special hello to Steve Kelly up in Portland, Maine. Listening, he's with the Ocean, 97.9 WCSO. Looking forward to WCW, headed to the Northeast.
Forget Steve Kelly. I got a question for Dusty. Talking about Mother's Day, you're doodling little hearts on your paper here. What'd you get for your mom?
For Mother's Day, I always send my mom flowers. When I can't send the flowers, I send her a note saying the flowers are coming.
That's what I thought, cheapskate.
What did you do?
I bought my mother another Mercedes.
I'm lost for words, and that's hard to make me be.
On a 120 scale, she can set it right up on the mantle on the fireplace. The gambler now, ready for the Cobra. I'm just trying to rescue that little bit there, that's all.
Rescue what?
Nothing. This coming
Monday night. It's WCW Nitro. VK Wall Street takes on the Nature Boy Ric Flair, who is here this morning up against Dirty Dick Slater. What a great match that's going to be. Public Enemy against the Steiners. And, of course, the Giant takes on Lex Luger. Just maybe Lex Luger can find a way to be on time this Monday night. It is 7 p.m. Eastern on TNT, live from Nashville.
I said it earlier in the show. It's an unusual situation. Giant, the heavyweight championship of the world, but Lex Luger, not a man to walk away from anything. He has some transportation problems, donated his time to charity. He will be there Monday night.
Dusty,
let me tell you something about Lex Luger. It is fishy, Larry, Legend, Zabisco. I know you have your own agenda, but let me tell you something about Lex Luger. That's your opinion, and my opinion different on him. When you have a match of the magnitude of the world's heavyweight title, I mean, you make sure you are mentally ready for it. And now he's saying, this is what I can't get. He gonna camp out in Nashville, Tennessee, so he don't miss this thing. I can't wait for WCW Monday Night Raw.
Well, I don't think he's literally gonna be sleeping on the cement in the parking space, but he'll be down at the big hotel
at
right next door.
He'll be down to Y.
A shot there from the gambler to paraphrase, speaking of Lex Luger, to paraphrase the great war reporter, correspondent Peter Arnett from CNN. He inhabits a world that encourages deception, a place where misrepresentation and subterfuge are a means to an end. That's what Lex Luger is all about. And what Gambler is all about is finding a chiropractor when this match is over. Wow.
Yeah, Cobra nailed him twice right there. Gambler starting to think, though. Roll out when you can't see the daylight. Recover, but Gambler doesn't look like he's recovering too successfully out here.
Dusty, tonight on WCW Saturday Night, Otani, the new cruiserweight champion.
On Saturday night?
Tonight.
Oh,
Saturday
he hit
night,
the pole!
We'll see him and next week.
That's what I said, on Saturday night.
Right. And then next week on WCW Worldwide, he defends that title against Dean Malenko. Check your local listings for time and station for Worldwide Wrestling.
Let me go back real quick to this thing right here with the gambler, right where we should be, with the gambler and the Cobra. Cobra trying to get better as the year went on. But I'm going to tell you what, gambler has been on the verge, Larry, lately, of winning a match right here on WCW Pro.
He's getting more aggressive. You cannot come in here and play with the big boys if you're not going to go 3,000% anymore. They're coming out of the woodwork. We got guys that will do anything to win, to make it to the top of that ladder of success. Gambler, he needs cash to play cards.
Hammerlock, and he jams the Cobra into the turnbuckle. Also tonight on WCW Saturday Night, Hulk Hogan, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Sugar Ray Leonard, at a charity event. We'll have exclusive video for you of that and more about Diamond Dallas Page. Maybe we'll find out who was in that limo. The gambler now with a modified hammerlock and slams the Cobra.
He's got
into the mat.
He's got to go in his way right here. He needs to go ahead and try to put him away. The gambler seems to be in a hurting situation. I mean, the Cobra. And the gambler got him stretched out right here.
Yeah, here's got his nice center of gravity. Could be a little bit more over the lower back of Cobra. That way he won't be able to scoot those hips out and get back to his feet. Definitely getting more aggressive. Gambler wants the survivor, the Cobra. He got out from under him.
He sure did. Big arms there, but certainly the left arm has been worked on by the gambler. Shades of the Andersons as the gambler goes to work on the one body part. And now the whip to the far ropes. Oh, gambler goes to the breadbasket with great effect. Great impact. The whip again on Cobra. Gambler can do no wrong here.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. Cobra with a beautiful suplex.
Well, that was a good move by Cobra. Now see if he can regroup, get himself back together, and get himself a victory right here on WCW Pro this morning.
Oh, he caught him right underneath the chin there. That's a soft spot.
Those legal forearm blows, the whip now. Look at this, a belly to belly over the top of the head. He plants him after the throw. The Cobra looking great. He is so powerful. He's signaling now for the Cobra clutch. Into the Cobra slam. If he gets it,
got
this
it.
Will do it.
Got him.
Here comes the 1-2-3 gambler. A good showing, but not yet at the level of the ever-improving Cobra. When we come back, it's our main event. The Nature Boy, Ric Flair, takes on Dirty Dick Slater. And in a few moments, blood runs cold on TBS. Don't go away.
Oh.
what a WCW Monday Nitro that was, but we've got more coming up this Monday,
I'm
going
to tell you what, this Monday Nitro, WCW TNT Monday Nitro, 7 p.m. start time, Eastern. We're going to have some settling words, I believe, going on about that situation. The Macho Man, you take a hardcore look at Luger, I'm going to be camping out. I guarantee you guys, we're hotter than ever with the big boys play.
Why they call him Dirty Dishwasher?
You tell him, Colonel.
Maybe he'll be on time this time for, supposedly, is a very important date with destiny for Luger, the Giant. You'd think that he, that nothing could keep him away from being on time for the World Heavyweight Championship match.
Yeah, and don't listen to these weekend wrestling idiots who think Jimmy Hart's behind some kind of intrigue, whether the Giant's got the championship, whether Lex Luger has it. I don't think it matters. It's all the same to Jimmy Hart. And watch the history, like I said earlier, the gold follows Jimmy Hart.
Well, I'm not a weekend, one of them weekend guys, that I know I'm not as old as you've been in wrestling long you have, Larry.
Stop it.
But I would definitely say that Jimmy Hart is a snake in the grass, and he's got something to do with this thing with Jimmy Hart.
Well, we'll find out later.
Lex Luger.
Right now, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the dirtiest man in wrestling of them all? Could well be Dick Slater.
And we'll have this main event match, Ric Flair against Dick Slater, in a moment here on TBS. Don't go away. WCW Pro on TBS, cruise along with Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Larry Zbyszko, the living legend.
What, Dusty? What?
He's dying to say something. I think he knows who's in the limousine.
I'm going
to
tell you what. What a matchup main event we got right here. Nobody any meaner, as you said, Larry Legends of Zbyszko, than Dirty Dick Slater, and the man that claimed to be the dirtiest player in the game, the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Woman out there, we got a set in here, brother, for a good, good matchup.
Yeah, well, we'll definitely find out who's capable of being the dirtiest player in the game. Both of these men have been around long enough. They're expert at that human game of chess we love so much where the big boys play it.
Why is it never checkers?
Hey, Chris, you know
any idiot can play checkers.
Standing side headlock there by Dirty Dick Slater.
Let me tell you what, Chris, you know, I mean, we're going to talk about focus in this match right here. And you know why I really think to keep this thing whole for Slater? That is, Colonel Parker got to stay focused on what he's doing on the outside. Because there is kind of even to score up with Woman and Colonel Parker, you know what I mean?
That's a very
so
good
now,
point.
Let's get it on right in the middle.
Indeed, and Dick Slater bringing it to Ric Flair.
Yeah, Flair, he doesn't want to, you know, sit there and play fisticuffs with Slater. Slater, he can knock out a horse. He loves to brawl. He thrives on it. You know Slater, Dusty. This guy's been shot, stabbed, and just caught Flair in a swinging neck breaker.
Yeah, but he's very, very knowledgeable, if you will. Knowledgeable of mat wrestling also. We talked about that. You know what I mean? So that thing is, he can use all that, and Flair too. I mean,
Dusty, I think you might agree that the reason, one of the reasons for the longevity of both Dirty Dick Slater and Ric Flair is that, indeed, they do have the mat basics. They are able to wrestle, and they're also able to adapt to the different styles of their opponents.
Yeah, and on the other thing too, is a thumb in the eye. I mean,
you know, talking about adaptability, this Monday night on Nitro, Ric Flair faces VK Wall Street.
What?
I'm just trying to tie it all in. VK Wall Street this Monday against the Nature Boy Ric Flair on Nitro.
Well, Ric Flair's got his hands full today against Dirty Dick Slater. You see him a jabbing and a punching. I don't think, Larry, he wants to get in a fifth fight with Dick Slater.
This is what Flair wants to do right here. He wants to get Dirty Dick down on the mat. Of course, that's a lot easier said than done, and Slater saw him coming.
Indeed he did. You know, the Nature Boy, obviously very famous for the figure four. This is the spinning toe hold there.
Slater missed it, though.
Yeah, he missed it both times. Got it back there.
Well, now he's got
it hooked. Yeah, got to hook that ankle. Sometimes that is not an easy task.
Slater already has very weakened knees after more than 20 years in this extremely difficult sport.
Well, how do you know that?
Look at the way he walks.
Well, he always walked like that.
Like a duck?
No, bow-legged.
Oh,
he caught Flair on the top rope.
He sure did. Flair will fly right flat on his back.
Now then, Colonel Parker, I want him to turn up the wicket.
Now, Parker in the background, and in the foreground, of course, Woman. They both know that this is high stakes here.
She is devilish, and she's screaming like a Comanche out there. I guarantee
you. Comanche?
Yeah, man. Yeah. You ever seen
I give up.
I hunt them all the time. Little bitty old bird. Scream like a Comanche.
A straight right from the heavily take fist there of Dirty Dick Slater.
Look at Flair's trying to get away from him. Oh, he blocked it.
And Flair is really telegraphing them, and Slater with that hard, big old head of his. What is this? The figure four?
You don't have to telegraph Slater. He's been around long enough. He can see him coming, and hey, if he falls back, he's got Flair in his own hole.
Right in the middle of the ring, and this could do it. Dick Slater is about to defeat the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Uh-oh. Devilish. Oh, I'm telling you. Devilish woman. That woman is so devilish.
Aren't they all?
I'll tell you what, though. He had him right there in a figure four. A little dose of his own medicine on what? What you said?
I'm trying to figure out what you said.
Excuse me.
What did he say?
I don't know.
They have addiction.
I can only speak English and Spanish. And look at they what?
He's got him in the sleeper now. And Slater, he knows how to put this on. It looks like Flair's trying to keep his head off to the one side, but he's going for the rope, so Slater must have it hooked good.
Well, he made it to the rope. No, boy, I said I have been training with addiction coach. And it ain't what you said. It's what did you say? That's better.
What did he mean?
Oh, wiped
hey,
out right
outside.
Here.
That's the side he doesn't want to be on. There's Colonel Parker.
And Slater, what's he got? Oh, man, I didn't think he was going to fly like Jushin Thunder Liger, but certainly I figured he put the boots to Ric Flair.
That's just as good. Are you talking about boots, too? We're talking about heavy cowboy boots that Dirty Dick Slater wearing to the ring.
A grueling match for the Nature Boy here on WCW Pro on TBS. It's our main event.
Hey!
Flair trying to suplex Slater outside the ring.
Slater can wind up in the third row ringside. He reverses it.
Got him up. Wow. Boy, he's taking the most and making the most out of this opportunity and knocking at his door. I'm talking about Dirty Dick Slater.
He's Slater cautious, doesn't rush into Flair.
Man, Flair again telegraphing. What is he thinking? Uh-oh. Like that four now, unanswered blows, and Flair is flat out. What is Slater waiting for?
Hey, only fools rush in where wrestlers fear to tread. Slater's making sure his moves are precision, but look, he had his head too far over.
Let me tell you.
Hey.
And Flair digs down. I think he's realizing he needs some extra help there. Oh, Slater is knocked out.
I'll tell you what, you know, this is the second occasion that something like this has happened to Dick Slater. Just recently on WCW Saturday Night, once again, woman was involved in that. And now, this thing that he took out of his tights has cost Slater another maybe victory for him. I guarantee you, that was close.
A very satisfied-looking woman realizing that the Nature Boy truly in trouble and needed help. And Flair dug down deep. And he ended up defeating the Nature Boy. I beg your pardon, Dirty Dick Slater. There is the Nature Boy victorious. We'll see that again in our slow motion instant replay.
Well, as knowledgeable as Dirty Dick Slater is, Nature Boy Ric Flair proved he is truly the dirtiest player in the game. Of course, with a little help from woman that goes a long, long way, Nature Boy snuck one out over Dirty Dick Slater here on the Pro.
And indeed, the Nature Boy ready for his contest this Monday night, 7 p.m. Eastern, on our sister network, TNT. He faces VK Wall Street, also on Nitro, the Giant, against the total package, Lex Luger. Dirty Dick Slater almost defeating the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, if not for some misapplied holds, including that spinning toe hold.
Well, Ric Flair proved again, dirtiest player in the game. He's going to have a hard time, though, with Slambery, unlucky draw, Macho Man, the partner. We all know the state of insanity, Savage is recent. I don't think this is even going to make it to the ring, and what a blow to Ric Flair, who desperately wants to become Lord of the Ring.
Tomorrow, of course, it is Mother's Day, but tonight it is WCW Saturday Night Hulk Hogan, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Sugar Ray Leonard.
We'll take a look at Hulkamania out there doing all the fine public work that he does for all the charities. A big special on Hulkamania tonight, right on Saturday night, the mothership with the Silicon Queen Savannah. Steiners matched up together, maybe for the last time, before Slambery against public enemy on Saturday night tonight. And the Sting and VK Wall Street, it's going to be hot as we leave in to Monday Night Raw live on WCW TNT, 7 p.m. We'll talk about it all tonight. And we stirred it up enough today. But let me tell you something. Remember I say this, Larry Legend, for this show. Give me hot with a stick of the grass, and he's behind
one Lex Luger.
Also news about Diamond Dallas Page.
He's also behind the giant, and the snake in the grass only bites the foot that steps on.
And we'll see you tonight on WCW Saturday Night. In Orlando, Florida. It's WCW Pro on TBS. Hi, everyone. Good morning, and welcome to the Pro on this, the Slammery Lethal Lottery Weekend. The waiting is over. I cruise along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the living legend, Larry Zbysko. And Larry, as we saw at the beginning of the program, the giant doing something to Lex Luger that no one has ever done to the total package.
Yeah, well, Luger can thank his lucky stars. He's a genetic wonder. He'll survive. But I told everybody so. I told everybody Lex Luger was trustworthy. And to all you armchair champions, you weekend wrestlers, you nosy little internet nitwits, let this be a lesson to you when I say something. It's true. Lex Luger is a man Sting can trust. And is that what he had to do? Lay his life on the line to prove it to all the doubting Thomas.
Well, if Lex Luger has his lucky stars, he also has Sting to thank, Dusty.
I didn't see it just like that. My notion to Lex Luger remained the same. Never, and I mean never, in the history of film or tape has anything been caught so devastating, so unbelievably, as the giant choke slamming one Lex Luger on the table. Now what lies ahead for him, I don't know.
And now we take you to the ring. As always, it is a jam-packed arena here at the Disney MGM Studios. And we are getting ready for the man whose ultimate goal, whose only goal, is to end Hulkamania, the Taskmaster.
All right there, Kevin Sullivan, filled to the brim with hate for Hulkamania. I think he's the chief member of the Alliance. And oh, he's going to end Julio right here.
Well, apparently Julio has done something to anger the Taskmaster.
Well, I think the Taskmaster has already been angered, all the time. Let me tell you something about the Taskmaster. He is bent on destroying Hulkamania. But guys, we talked about it in the open, and I will say it once again. I have never seen a more devastating move. Pictures are worth a thousand words if you haven't seen it. The bottom line, Lex Luger, I mean, the giant put him to waste, brother. What an awesome, awesome display of power.
Yeah, on the other hand, so much for the people, again, who have been skeptics of the total package. It's sometimes not pleasant to eat our words, but I suggest most people get the fork.
The giant doing something that nobody has ever done to Lex Luger. And I think it was instructive to note that even the giant backed off when he realized that Luger may have been just out of it. As the Taskmaster continues to try to make Julio Sanchez out of it. A lot going on tonight on WCW Saturday Night. We'll be talking about that, about Monday Nitro, and this is, of course, the Slammery Weekend. Oh, man, what has this kid done?
Well, I'll tell you what, the Taskmaster's throwing a mud hole in him. He's been all offense from the get-go. And I guarantee you, nobody any meaner, any better than the Taskmaster has proven that. And is bent on destroying Hulkamania. And the Taskmaster now taking Julio Sanchez to task right here on Saturday morning.
You know, let me point out something very interesting here, guys. Notice who's at ringside with the Taskmaster. That's the mental giant himself, Jimmy Hart. Talk about Monday Nitro when the Taskmaster's in the corner of Arn Anderson. Jimmy Hart's going to be in the corner of the giant. Something's going on here.
You know, about 40 years ago on television.
Well, don't comment on that. Look at, there he is right there, Mr. Hart.
Well, indeed, that is Jimmy Hart. I mean,
okay, thank you for commenting. Go ahead.
Can I please?
Go ahead.
40 years ago on television, the $64,000 question premiered. And that is, I think, the $64,000 question. What has this Julio Sanchez kid done? Maybe he's aligned himself with Hulk Hogan or tried to.
He's probably
here it comes.
Probably more aligned with the Three Stooges.
He got him right there. Stumped the mud hole in him.
Now
He's going to do it. Taskmaster victorious over Julio Sanchez. The conclusion of this match never in doubt. We just didn't expect the Taskmaster to do what he did to Sanchez.
She doesn't like Sanchez either.
Not quite sure that's the correct interpretation. We'll see this again. Taskmaster victorious here on WCW Pro. Well, wait a minute. Going after a man in a wheelchair? Hey, has he lost his mind?
Handicapped people don't have the right to shoot their mouths off any more than anybody else does. Just because he gets a free parking space.
Not see this again. It is the Pep Boys Instant Replay. America's Auto Parts Superstore. Our Pep Boys Power Pin of the Week.
Well, here's a power slap of the week, and that was Julio's body bouncing off the cement. Right here, talk about stomping Taskmaster. He can do it as vicious as anybody, but still, the presence of Jimmy Hart with this man leads questions to the upcoming Nitro when Jimmy Hart will also be in the corner of the Giant.
A whole lot more to come here on WCW Pro. Don't go away. Well, we saw it again, but it still has tremendous impact. The Giant, with one hand chokeslamming Lex Luger through the table. Thank goodness he moved the candelabras. You never know what shape Luger would have been in.
Luger didn't look in very good shape at all. Candelabras or not.
But it's got a really gross sting into a situation once again to where now he's having to deal with the Giant and at Slammarie, only on pay-per-view this weekend. Bottom line, guys, we're going to be there on that big main event, too.
Live.
That will be on TBS. It's going to be live, and we're going to tell you a lot of time there's some evil stuff happening on that main event there, and I guarantee you what a weekend we got going here, Slammarie weekend, going to WCW Monday Nitro Live coming up this Monday, tonight on Saturday night. But something interesting here, guys, when you take a logical look at this situation, what is BK Wall Street, Larry, doing with one of the men at work as his partner?
Well, obviously, he got himself in a situation here with, you know, Craig Pittman and Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and he needs somebody, so I think he might have went to the union, looks like to me. He's got to pay union wage, I would imagine.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan being accompanied to the ring, at least he's scheduled to in a moment. There he is, Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman, and, of course, Teddy Long.
Teddy Long, spiritual advisor and motivator, deluxe, my man, Teddy Long.
Motivator deluxe. Look at Teddy Long, he's got a custom-built head complete with cathedral ceiling.
Nice. All right, as we said, it is a Slammarie, a Battle Ball Lethal Lottery weekend, the Lord of the Ring to be crowned. Those incredible teams that have been drawn essentially at random, Ric Flair and the Macho Man Randy Savage on the same team. Larry, I know you said that match will not even come on.
Well, I tell you what, on this past Monday Nitro, the Macho Man Randy Savage, excuse me, Larry, I'm going to step in here, because the bottom line is he was not let in the building, tried on numerous occasions. And something else coming out of this past Monday Nitro, we got to address before this thing gets underway, and that is our colleague, Mr. Mongo McMichael, Del T. Hobbs, Texas himself, said, hey, my feathers are ruffled just a little bit, my friends, and I guarantee it. And he said, my friend, and I'll tell you what, he's going to be right for somebody.
Well, he may be your colleague. He's not my colleague.
Aren't you in a good mood on this Slammarie weekend? Hey, you know, we talked about Nitro. We saw some video from Nitro to begin this segment. The Giant is back at Nitro. He's going to be facing Arn Anderson this Monday night. Sting and Lex Luger against the Faces of Fear and Ric Flair against Eddie Guerrero.
I wonder what kind of shape Lex Luger's in. I've never seen anything so devastating. I've seen guys that get hit with plunder tables and chairs before. I have never seen anything with the impact as he hit that table like that. And I guarantee you, man, I mean, they've got to be going through his mind and Sting's mind what's going to happen now.
Has never happened to Lex Luger. Believe it. I mean, this man is 275 pounds. But, of course, we've got to keep in mind the major announcement as well. Made it Nitro this month. 2 hours live each and every Monday night on TNT. And Duggan almost cracking the 14-year veteran, VK Wall Street. 248 pounds, 6'3", this man. As well as Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman, a man to be reckoned with.
Well, Pittman's at home on the mat, no question about it, but then so is Mr. Wall Street. I think Pittman's only problem is Teddy Long softening him up.
Now, what Pittman is doing so much better now, got his focus right because of Teddy Long. And Teddy Long and Hacksaw Jim Duggan have got together, and Pittman now, as you said, Larry, great mat wrestler that VK Wall Street is, but Pittman taking him down.
Whoa.
There you go.
Modified fireworks carry takeover, and you're right. Pittman does get him right over.
Well, Pittman knows the moves, but he needs to be as vicious, I think, as he once was. And I think that's what Teddy Long has sacrificed.
And, well, look at this. BK Wall Street tags in Mark Starr for Men at Work. He doesn't want anything to do with Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
This is an unusual matchup, much like we will see at Slamboree, only on pay-per-view this weekend, coming from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, when we see the different matchups, the brothers against brothers, the teams against teams, the men against each other, all vying to go to win the Lord of the Ring, the Lethal Lottery, Slamboree. And Sting, my friend, has an opportunity knocking at his door with the Giant, and he's got to be right emotionally to win the World Heavyweight title.
Well, I can see the Giant throwing Sting right through the door. He picked up Luger like a piece of paper. We saw what he did to the genetic wonder himself. Sting's smaller man, weaker man than Lex Luger. I don't think Sting's got a chance.
I saw Jim Duggan, the pride of Glens Falls, New York. He's going to be facing the Barbarian tonight. On WCW Saturday night here on TBS, it's Sting against Meng. We'll see Jushin Thunder Liger in action as Pittman hits the ring. He's ready for Mark Starr.
But Mark Starr, though, he's thinking. Look at, he backs up, not rushing into Pittman. Probably the influence of Mr. Wall Street there. Mark Starr could learn a lot from Wall Street. Right there, don't play beat the clock, kid. Just take your time against a man with cauliflowered ears.
Hey, and you know what? We talk about WCW Saturday night with the big boys play the mothership tonight. Me and Tony Schiavone, silver tongue. But let me tell you something, too. Dallas Page, first time seeing him back. Still wondering that glove that stuck out of that limo that brought him in, that white glove. Who is the benefactor there that's brought him back to life? Maybe tonight we'll find out on Saturday night.
Find it hard to believe that we are still seeing Diamond Dallas Page.
Hey,
we got rid of him. I thought he was gone.
I told you, Diamond Dallas, an underestimated talent. This guy is great. A little confused when it comes to women, but what man is it until we wise up? All the man needed was a chance. Mark my words, Diamond Dallas will be a force if he's got the right backer here. Who is the guy anyway?
We don't know. The white glove.
Hey, is it a guy?
Well, you got a good point there.
Oh.
BK Wall Street rolled over. Whoa. And Pittman kicked right smack in the head. His belt has come off. Look out. Wall Street may use that as a weapon. The referee smartly getting it out of the ring. Now the whip on the far rope, and look at that beautiful move there by Wall Street, and Pittman goes down. Still to come this morning on the Pro. What a tag team match. Harlem Heat against Masachono and Masa Saito. That is this morning right here on TBS on the Pro.
We got a mess of Masa there.
Would you please? A scoop. And look out. Wall Street misses the elbow. Pittman has taken some real punishment in this match, and he is crawling his way toward Duggan.
Well, he needs to get a tag to Hacksaw Jim Duggan, get them big old ham hocks in there, and let him start dealing on them. And Hacksaw can deal. Get that tag. Got it.
In comes Hacksaw. Wall Street doesn't realize it.
Well, he does now.
Yeah, he sure does. Whoa. And Mark Starr and Wall Street, the double nugget knocker.
Wow, there he goes again. Hacksaw got hands like bowling balls on him, but not much of a brain. Didn't even think Wall Street would be there. Big dummy.
Uh-oh, well, here we go. Duggan, he ducks. Look out.
Oh, man, what'd I tell you? Shades of Slamboree.
Yeah, indeed. Oh, Pittman with some momentum there, and Mark Starr is out. The double close.
Wall Street.
They got him. He's going to pin him. He's got three. Duggan has pinned BK Wall Street. Wow, what a surprise.
Well, that just goes to show you, when you got a partner in there you're not used to, look at this Slamboree only on pay-per-view this weekend from Baton Rouge. I guarantee you, things like this can happen in a more volatile way. A
lot of intrigue surrounding it. This is the weekend. Brothers may turn against brothers.
Well, the Warriors on opposite sides. Yeah. Steiner's on opposite sides. And Wall Street has attacked his own partner. Well, what is he thinking?
Hey, in this case here, I don't blame BK Wall Street. But this just goes to show you. You can't be in there with somebody that don't know what they're doing or know what you're getting ready to do to try to win a match.
Hey, sometimes the young and the useless need a motivator to stand out of their ignorance.
An unfortunate attack from behind by BK Wall Street on young Mark Starr. Man. All right, a whole lot more to come here on WCW Pro, including our main event. Chris Benoit takes on Brad Armstrong. We're back in a moment.
tomorrow night live from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. It's Slamboree in the Lethal Lottery and Battle Bowl. It will be one of the most important and exciting events in pay-per-view history. Hi, I'm Gene Okerlund, back at the Control Center. World Championship Wrestling going live starting at 7 o'clock Eastern Time tomorrow evening. Exclusively on pay-per-view, you can join us. It's as easy as a simple telephone call. Now, here's the rundown. First, WCW Heavyweight Champ, the Giant, to defend against Sting. In the corner, handcuffed to each other, Lex Luger and Jimmy Hart. That's a strange one. U.S. Champion Conan to meet his challenger, Jushin Thunder Liger. Then it's on to the first round of the Lethal Lottery with the Final Destination Battle Bowl. And here are those pairings. Randy Savage and Ric Flair forced to team up to meet Arn Anderson and Eddie Guerrero. Stevie Ray and Big Bubba tag against Fire and Ice, Scott Norton and Ice Train. Road Warrior Hawk and Lex Luger to meet the Road Warrior Animal and Booker T. Hugh Morris, Ming, Tango with the Barbarian, and the recently reinstated Diamond Dallas Page. The Taskmaster and Chris Benoit to meet Public Enemy. Alex Wright, Disco Inferno, meeting Dirty Dick Slater and the Earl of Eaton. The Booty Man and Rick Steiner, hopefully with the Booty Gal, the Booty Babe in their corner, square off against Sergeant Craig Pittman and Scott Steiner. Lord Steven Regal, Squire David Taylor to lock up with Hacksaw Jim Duggan and DK Wall Street. Once we get down to the final four teams, those eight men go to Battle Bowl, where it's going to be every man for himself. And, of course, the winner will be crowned the Lord of the Ring and will meet the WCW Heavyweight Champion Baltimore next month. It's Slamboree, it's the Lethal Lottery, it's Battle Bowl. It's tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, live and only on pay-per-view. Call your cable company right now, satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier or DirecTV. It's going to be extraordinary, exciting. It is Slamboree.
Now of the Slamboree Battle Bowl Lethal Lottery, Lord of the Ring to be determined this Sunday night, and the Lord of the Ring gets a shot at the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World. And the Great American Bash fans, make that phone call. Your local cable companies are standing by this weekend to take your orders for Slamboree. Ask for it by name as Steve Dahl prepares to meet the Booty Man. Dusty, I think you'd agree. Our colleague Eric Bischoff on WCW Monday Nitro called Slamboree possibly this year one of the most interesting, exciting, and certainly unique pay-per-views ever.
Well, anytime you get a situation like we got right here at WCW, where everybody's hot and everybody's wanting that same goal, you know, Sting and Giant going for the...
Whoa! Holy moly!
You okay?
Yes, I tell you what, bring me my medicine, bring me my medicine. That's the Booty Babe, Kimberly right there with the Booty Man getting ready to get out. Yes, it is. It will be an unbelievable event. Main event's going to kick it off live on TBS. Talking about tomorrow night, and so much happens on that thing that leads you in to Slamboree 1996.
Yeah, that he right.
You know, I'm looking at, I'm looking at the Booty Babe here, and I just had an awful vision in my mind.
And what is that vision that you actually had? That you were there when the honeymoon was premiered, and
no,
you were 11 years old.
About that. I'm saying is, do you think it's possible that Kimberly was in the limousine that drove away Diamond Dallas Page?
Hey, no.
There's a connection there. Hey. Wait a minute. We've seen what she's done to other men. Cast them aside like every other woman does after they get the money. Popped in there.
Make no mistake about it. The Booty Man and Kimberly the Booty Babe are really digging each other. And the bottom line, she's with him. And she wearing a white glove. We seen a white glove come out of that limousine and pull Dallas Page in from obscurity back to the limelight.
Maybe she was just wearing a white glove to hide the hand.
Oh, you cannot hide her. You can't hide her in a...
Talking about the hand.
You cannot hide her in a bushel of corn. You know what I'm talking about?
The colored elbow tie up. All right, let's try to maintain our focus.
It's him.
It's tough when the Booty Babe is around. It's Armed Forces Day, and our special salute going out to all the men and women of the Armed Forces serving throughout the world in uniform and great sacrifices they are making for our country. Yeah. And Booty Man.
Well, Steve Dahl said, I'm going to go ahead and deal on him because this is my Slamboree. I ain't going nowhere. I need a victory right here on the pro this
morning. Larry, just a clarification on what Dusty said. It was 20 years ago this week that the honeymoon is premiered.
Who cares? Right there, Booty Man, big guy. Giving it back to Steve Dahl. All of a sudden, don't care.
Well, he's a willing on him now.
Is it the Honeymooners? Was that the show starring Miss Elizabeth and Macho?
Hey, now.
Speaking of Macho, couldn't get in the building.
No.
Hopefully, be letting him in. WCW Monday Nitro coming live on TNT this Monday night.
Oh.
And that's going to be an explosive situation. Oh, look at those knee lifts there by the Booty Man, because Ric Flair is going to be in the building at Nitro. He's facing Eddie Guerrero, and that's going to do it. Booty Man is going to get the 1-2-3. Yeah, that's, as we think about it, of course, they are supposed to team Nature Boy Ric Flair and Randy Savage.
One thought for you. What will be left of either man after Slamboree only on pay-per-view 1996 in Baton Rouge tomorrow?
Hey, fans, listen to this match as they bump booties. It's Harlem Heat against Masachono and Masa Saito next right here on the program.
Go ahead.
A scorching rumor working its way through the world of professional wrestling, and it involves a huge star that might just be leaving his current organization. I know my telephone has been ringing off the hook. I'm getting calls from Denver, from Los Angeles, from New York. Well, there's a lot of speculation that the well-known superstar I'm talking about could make a surprise appearance tomorrow night at Slamboree. Something I can't talk about on the air. It's only a rumor, but I'm going to have that hot story and more, especially as we head into Slamboree. That all happens today during my exclusive hotline report at 1-900-909-9900. Who's leaving? $1.49 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission before calling, but make that telephone call right now.
Thanks, Mean Gene. Where does he get his scoop?
He got all of it. He knows everything. You got to call him, too, because I tried to tell him, ask him to get some scoops, and you got to call him. He want me to call him, and I got to get my parents' permission before I do that. Hey, you got to be 18.
Okerlund's like a worm. He lives for dirt.
Gene and Julio down by the schoolyard, and they're getting the reports. There's Masachono on the left, Masa Saito on the right. What a devastating combination. This is
Sonny Ono, the Japanese version of Jimmy Hart Edwards.
Hey, don't say nothing bad about Sonny Ono. He gave us a good year.
Yeah, well, he helped out a little bit,
I
wasn't going to take the money at first, but I didn't. Did I say money? I shouldn't have said nothing.
My check ought to be here any day now.
It's in the mail, Cruz.
Thank you very much.
It's coming with your contract for next year.
They're going to face Harlem Heat this morning here on WCW Pro on this, the Slamboree weekend, fans. Time is quickly running out. You have got to make that call to your local cable company. It is a unique opportunity in World Championship Wrestling to see the Steiners face one another, see the Road Warriors face one another, and of course, Nature Boy Ric Flair and the Macho Man Randy Savage on the same team.
One more important thing. I think it's the last time anybody ever may see Sting wrestle again. We saw what happened to Lex Luger. The Giant could easily end Sting's career at Slamboree.
Yes, indeed, the Giant is defending the World Heavyweight Championship against the Stinger at Slamboree tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view. Still to come, Chris Benoit takes on Brad Armstrong. We're going to have a little bit more news about that kind of outer space thing.
Uh-oh.
Called Blood Runs Cold as NASA. Wow. Saito.
Mr. Tatcha himself. There is nobody that comes from that Orient, from that country over there, and all the great wrestlers that they have, all the great athletes that they have, any meaner, any badder, any uglier, if you will, than Masachono and Mr. Saito. Both these guys. Look at this.
Wow.
Jimmy Hart. There he is.
What is Sonny Ono?
That's Jimmy Hart in a Sonny Ono costume.
It's not Jimmy Hart.
I don't think this thing is going to be going on too much in the ring.
Well, if they want to fight outside with Harlem Heat, they're doing the wrong thing.
Absolutely.
Because Harlem Heat, they're in their element there.
Now the whip on Chono and a clothesline, and Stevie Ray with a cover just gets a one count.
They got him down. Sloppy cover, though. Chono, he knows what he's doing on that mat. So does Saito. They're both experts in that ring. Harlem Heat better keep moving. It's going to be a toss of the coin match here.
Now there's Booker T for the first time in the ring, and he's up against Masachono.
Well, they got him slowing down. Masachono is slowing down. A high kick right there. Got him. What do you call that, Larry?
High kick.
That's what I thought it was. That's why I called it that.
Or call it effective. Still to come, news about the WCW Cruiserweight Champion. Also, tonight at WCW Saturday Night, it's Sting against Mang. Kind of interesting that Sting will be going up against Mang the very night before he faces the Giant at Slamboree. He Bang is not backing off a bit.
All the more reason we may never see Sting again come Monday.
Also, Jushin Thunder Liger tonight, Dusty, as he prepares for his U.S. Heavyweight Championship shot against Conan at Slamboree.
Well, Sting backs down from no man, and also another man that backs down from no man, our colleague, my Texican, if you will, my homeboy. I'm talking about Mongo McMichael. He made a statement this past Monday Night Raw.
Yeah, and I can tell you what it was.
What?
I don't know, baby.
Oh, would you stop it?
Booker T in there now against Mr. Torture, Masa Saito.
Mr. Torture.
Oh, that Saito, he knows how to torture you. He loves it. He thrives on it. Any part of your body he grabs, he knows how to hurt it.
Represented Japan in the Olympics, and he is stomping away on Booker T. We have never seen the Harlem Heat manhandled so readily as we are seeing them manhandled by Chono and Saito.
Yeah, but they when they got in that fight outside earlier, they fell into Harlem Heat's deal, and Harlem Heat looked good there at the first start. Now they're coming back a little bit, so I don't know if they really got a hold on Harlem Heat.
An elbow there looks like to the throat, and Saito is backing off, and unfortunately Booker T is as well. Wait a minute.
Well,
don't
now
get suckered here.
He's having a little soliloquy with him right there, you know. I'm going to talk about it. And I know
that Booker T's not falling for it. Saito, a sneaky man.
And he misses two big clotheslines. And Booker T, such a unique, such a tremendous athlete. What a joy to watch him. And yeah, Saito slows him down.
He walks right into one. I mean, you leave an opening, Saito's going to find it. Even the phenomenal athlete that Booker T is, still hard to deal with a man of experience like Saito.
And Stevie Ray realizing that brother Booker T in a whole lot of trouble, and our cameras are showing that as well. What is Saito trying to do, rip his eyes out?
Yeah, but he put a torture hold, nervy hold, put a nervy hold and a torture hold on you, and even in your eye socket will make you hurt. So they should be concerned.
Now Masachono is tagged in, and Booker T needs to get Stevie Ray in, and quickly.
Well, that's easier said than done. Chono, he's got him blocked off from his partner. Oh, kicked him right in the mouth, man.
You talk about an athlete, Masachono, represent Japan. There's nobody finer, as I said, about Masaito and Masachono the same way. Oh, they're dealing on him there in the corner.
What a brutal match this has been for the Harlem Heat and for Chono and Saito, the whip. Stevie Ray moves in, but not quickly enough. Oh, Chono is going to follow up on that one.
And he just tagged Saito in. I think Stevie Ray knocked the wind out of himself in the corner. Saito has no mercy.
Oh, short chops. Now the double whip. Missed the double clothesline. And look at that. From Stevie Ray. Beautiful move.
Yeah, but they're all down there.
Yeah, and you know, you see Sonobono out there, Sonobono from Japan. You know, we talk about Jimmy Hart being a snake in the grass. Sonobono is a snake in the rice paddock. You know what I mean? They're the same two animals. They're just from different continents.
Booker T taking it to both Chono and Saito. Executes those moves. Oh! Hey, standing drop kick, and he does it again. Is there anything this athlete can't do?
Well, they're firing on him now. Harlem Heat.
Well, one drop kick is not a victory make so far.
Get him.
Hey, well, come on, guys.
Get him.
Leave him alone. He's got the checkbook.
Pick him up. Get him.
They are missing out here. They are losing their focus. Sonny Ono is doing exactly what he wants to do, and that is distracting the Harlem Heat.
Distracting? He's backing away from the guys.
Well, they're out in the street with it now. Hey, muscle. Mr. Saito, throw him in, but he knows he can't beat him outside.
Sounds like you got a tongue stuck in your mouth.
Yeah, I do.
Oh,
and it's longer than the Nile River.
Whoa! Whoa! A flying for... Huh? A flying for... Don't repeat that. Wait a minute. The referee is saying, ring the bell.
Well, it's broken loose. He got the collar going into this.
Well, Patrick's a coward. He can't control this. He threw it out.
He is one of the finest
referees
ever.
He's one of the finest
WCW.
Cowards we have.
Look at him trying to get in that ring. He's doing the right thing. They just broke loose here. He got something on his hand.
Well, what is it? No wonder he got disqualified.
Well, I don't know what got into these two teams, but they have decided that they are going to throw out the rule book, and it looks like both teams are being disqualified. Over the top rope. Oh, goes Saito.
What a shot.
And Harlem Heat this morning here on TBS on WCW Pro from the Disney MGM Studios.
Nothing,
wait a minute.
Nothing settled here. There's nothing settled here with Harlem Heat.
Well, Stevie Ray doesn't look too happy about it. Neither does Booker T. Jono Saito, two masters in the ring. Harlem Heat couldn't beat him. And that's the bottom line.
When we come back, news about the WCW Cruiserweight title. Our main event is Chris Benoit against Brad Armstrong, and blood runs cold. Today, tonight on WCW Saturday Night, Sting, after the trauma he has gone through, faces Meng. Of course, you know, the trauma being seeing Lex Luger devastated by the Giant.
Well, this Slamboree weekend, getting ready for the Lethal Lottery in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, tomorrow tonight on WCW Saturday Night, Sting and Meng. Emotionally, where is Sting? Stood by Lex Luger, hung with him through it all, even though me personally still calling him a stick in the grass. And when he was chokeslammed, came to his rescue. Mentally has to be prepared for the biggest weekend of his life. I'm talking Sting.
Indeed, Sting is ready. And now, Larry, our main event, we're ready. It's the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit taking on Brad Armstrong.
It's going to be a great game of human chess. You know, both these guys are ready. Brad Armstrong, great competitor. Chris Benoit, I believe in terms of tenacity and all-around balance, Chris Benoit may be ahead on top.
All right, now we take you to this match involving these two great cruisers. What a challenge Brad Armstrong has ahead of him here this morning on the main event on WCW Pro on TBS. He's going to face the 10-year veteran, the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit, at 5'11 and 235 rock solid pounds. The fourth horseman makes his way to the ring.
Well, let me tell you something about Chris Benoit. This man and the man we seen earlier start off this morning's pro taskmaster, being partners, having to coexist, if you will, at Slammery only on pay-per-view. And I guarantee it's going to be an explosive situation tomorrow in Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
You know, really, tomorrow, intrigue of a lifetime. Teams will self-destruct, no doubt about it. Brother, I see turning against brother, but the man who becomes the Lord of the Ring will be the most vicious man of all.
Well, very good point. And as this match proceeds, we'll be telling you a lot more about what's coming up tonight on WCW Saturday Night. Also, tomorrow, I beg your pardon, this Monday on Nitro, of course, we got the big news that Nitro going to 2 hours live, starting in just a couple of weeks on our sister network, TNT. Quick reminder, the new WCW Cruiserweight Champion, Otani, with his first title defense this weekend on WCW Worldwide. Check your listings for local time and station. He faces the Canadian, I beg your pardon, the former partner of the Canadian crippler, Dean Malenko.
Yeah, that out. That is so true. And let me tell you something about Brad Armstrong. This man here has really, I'm talking about when he said in 1996, I'm going to get off, he got off.
All right, we're back in a moment. The participants are ready here in the main event on WCW Pro on TBS this morning, and so are we, Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbyszko and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. It's Brad Armstrong, who made it far, Dusty, in the Cruiserweight tournament, but was not able to capture that new title here in WCW. He's up against the Canadian crippler, Chris Benoit.
Well, Brad Armstrong didn't surprise me, but surprised a lot of people, and I guarantee you, as I said, well, he got off in 96 and said, I'm going to really do something about the situation of Brad Armstrong, take care of myself, and move on up the ladder. And that's what he did. This matchup here, both guys got speed, moves, they know all the holes, they're veterans. This should be a good one.
Yeah, it'd be very good, but let me tell you why I like Benoit. Benoit is one of the fastest regainers of balance I've ever seen, except myself. Brad Armstrong, very good, but Benoit has a little more snap to him, and I think that might be the deciding straw that breaks the Armstrong's back. Oh, nice arm drag.
A beautiful counter there by Armstrong. Followed up with a great drop kick.
Yeah, I'm just getting ready to mention the drop kick. You taking one road, I take the other. I really believe Brad Armstrong is too quick for Chris Benoit. I think his quickness will bring him out in the end of this thing.
Benoit scheduled
to bet a dollar?
To team up with the Taskmaster at Slamboree in one of those odd pairings tomorrow night, live on pay-per-view, preceded, of course, by the main event live. Whoa. Oh, look at that, drop toe hold there. And Benoit goes mush first into the mat. Also, the Steiner brothers on opposite sides, Road Warriors on opposite sides, and Ric Flair and the Macho Man. Oh, man.
They're really on opposite sides.
Yeah, but on the same team.
Yeah, and Benoit Taskmaster, I mean, it is loaded. Slamboree only on pay-per-view. You don't want to miss it. You want to buy it. You want to call your cable system and you tune in. Come on out live on TBS
and we'll be bringing you what's going on and leading up to it. And usually there's so much happens on that main event, you don't want to miss nothing.
And we'll let you know about Sting's Requiem on Monday.
And Zagiri there. And tonight, of course, Sting faces Meng as he gets ready for his shot at the Giant for the World Heavyweight Championship. Tomorrow night at Slamboree, but can Sting even get through Meng tonight? On Saturday night, we'll find out. Also, Jushin Thunder Liger in action, and in action for the first time since he's been reinstated, Diamond Dallas Page.
He's got him down now, cut him off, got a headlock on him, keeping him down on the mat.
Armstrong doing the right thing there, I think you'd agree.
Well, he better keep him down, but as soon as Benoit, you know, gets a chance, just like here, works himself back up, always in command of balance.
Also, Sting and Lex Luger teaming up, of course, to take on the Faces of Fear at Nitro. The big announcement, Nitro going to 2 hours live every Monday night on TNT within the next couple of weeks. The Giant to face Arn Anderson, and if they let him into the building at Nitro, Macho Man in a special interview. The concern is that, of course, Ric Flair will be facing Eddie Guerrero at Nitro, and will Macho Man, after having teamed with him the previous night at Slamboree, well, can we trust him?
Well, the answer is going to be answered tomorrow night on pay-per-view at Slamboree. Right there, nice duck under. Another nice duck under going right back to the headlock.
Oh!
Got caught in a suplex. Made a mistake.
Right there, and that was a question of balance. And Chris Benoit answered it beautifully, even with the legs kicking to Brad Armstrong. He realized he was going down, couldn't do anything about it, because Benoit's got that little extra snap.
Up until now, Armstrong doing everything right, and now we'll see if Benoit, oh, look at this. Rides Armstrong to the skull of the back. Here's the lateral press, 1-2, and a kick out by Armstrong.
You're right there, Benoit, right back, boom, right back to the center of balance. Armstrong, he's suffering, his small of the back, definitely in pain. Come on, Benoit, don't forget them. Stay on, Brad.
And indeed, that's just what he's doing. A beautiful snap mare, and he pulls back onto the neck. How incredibly painful that must be.
Yeah, well, you put that knee right behind the base of the neck and yank back on the chin. You're making the Armstrong boys suffer here.
Well, it definitely is a true statement you made there, Legend Larry Zbysko. He needs to get out of this situation. Maybe bail out and regroup just a little bit. Take a page out of the Nature Boy Ric Flair's playbook. Because Benoit's really now just pulverizing, if you will, that back.
A reversal there by Armstrong. Oh, wait a minute. Whoa. Went for the leapfrog, and Benoit was ready. Great defense there.
Yeah, he just exploded with that elbow again, right in the mouth. Again, only able to do that because he has got tremendous amount of balance.
You know, there's so much wrestling going on this weekend. Maybe the best advice is just to tune in to WCW Pro, and of course Saturday night, tonight, and the main event tomorrow night, Slamboree and Nitro. Just keep the television tuned. The TBS, 1-2, and almost a 3. And then, live on pay-per-view, Slamboree, the lethal lottery. This could do it.
Whoa.
New small package. Beautiful inside cradle. And Armstrong gets a 2 count on the Canadian crippler.
Yeah, he tried to lace the leg, but Benoit, you know, turned his leg out of the way. That was a brilliant counter. Oh.
Armstrong, well, so simply just hung onto the top rope.
Benoit made his mistake there. Now let's see if Brad Armstrong can capitalize on it.
Beautiful uppercut, the whip into the far turnbuckle, back body drop, and Benoit goes over. He's up, but only on one knee.
But Armstrong's eyes, he's getting red there. He's starting to lose emotional control here.
Goes to the breadbasket, and Armstrong looks to be on his way to victory. A knee lift there. He goes for the cover, gets one, gets two, will he? Almost a slow count there by the referee. Oh, so close was Brad Armstrong.
Whoa, whoa.
A big miss there. There it is. The side Russian leg sweep. And it's blocked by Benoit.
Look at Benoit can even maintain balance. Going for the Russian leg sweep by Armstrong.
The what? The Russian leg sweep.
No, Russian leg sweep. All right there. Nice suplex. What a bridge.
That's going to do it.
Yes, it is.
1, 2, and 3.
Good victory. Big victory.
You owe me a dollar.
I didn't bet you.
Yes, you did.
I would never bet financial funds.
One of the four horsemen and proud of it, the Canadian crippler. Tough victory, but he made it over Brad Armstrong here on WCW Pro on TBS. We'll see that again in our slow motion instant replay. Victory as Benoit heads into Slamboree.
And I think we should. All these armchair champions here can learn from Chris Benoit right there. Exploded after Armstrong tried to drop it. Even though Armstrong caught himself, Benoit, excellent
excellent balance at all times. Look, it stuck up behind, locked those fingers. But what a snap on that suplex.
That's it. We'll see you tonight on Saturday night and tomorrow night on Slambery. Welcome to the Pro. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko and the American dream Dusty Rhodes. What a weekend we had. Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery, the live main event, and of course, an hour and a half live on WCW Monday Nitro as we prepare for 2 hours live on Nitro each and every week. And Larry, as we saw at Slamboree, it's going to be WCW against the NFL.
Well, you know, I've never heard anything so stupid in my life. No, they wanted me to play football when I was in high school and college. I was busy wrestling, and I didn't want to surround myself with 10 big, stupid idiots all covered in pads, killing themselves for nothing, trying to impress their daddy. Well, Kevin Green and Dumbo McMichaels are going to find out the hard way wrestling is a different ballgame.
Ric Flair, Arn Anderson looking to make an example of the NFL stars, and Sting defeated by the Giant at Slamboree, Dusty.
Well, so much happened at Slamboree. Now, as we move on, getting ready for the Great American Bash, as the legendary Larry Zbysko pointed out, I got different feelings about that situation. But let me tell you something, there's something rotten with Jimmy Hart and Luger in the Sting situation. I'm going to talk more about it today.
We sure are, and now we take you to the ring. What to them must be a humiliating loss in the first round of Slamboree. Lord Steven Regal and Squire David Taylor to be preceded by Jeeves. They lost to VK Wall Street and Hacksaw Jim Duggan at round one. And they're also, I think, a little bit concerned the way that Robert the Earl of Eaton is treating Jeeves. Maybe he's being too nice to him. Who knows?
You know, even to Lord Steven Regal, Jeeves is a peasant. But what the Earl of Eaton should do is exactly what the Squire does. Keep his mouth shut and listen to his lordship.
Well, again,
That's my suggestion.
As I said, Robert the Earl of Eaton is treating Jeeves nicely, and maybe Lord Steven Regal just doesn't like that. Dusty, I don't know.
Well, you know, when we talk about WCW, where the big boys play, the Pro Show on TBS this morning. We got so much to talk about. Taking a hard, cold look at Ninja Boy Ric Flair is here. Now, the Ninja Boy Ric Flair is the man, Larry Legend Zbysko, that has driven the Macho Man Randy Savage off the deep end. He's crazy. He's gone. He's out of here. He has been suspended from being on television, if you will.
Well, it's about time.
I mean, on TV. Now let me make this...
I mean, Savage is already... put referees in the hospital. The guy's nuts.
Well, let me make this clear to you. The Macho Man's still going to be in the arena for all the arena fans out there. Don't know what kind of mood he's going to be in. But television-wise, we can't see him no more, Christopher Cruz.
Oh, wait a minute. As I recall, Randy Savage is scheduled to face the Barbarian tonight.
I'm going to get in there a little later on. I got my feelings out trying to find out what's going on Saturday night, because he was scheduled for that event and everything. But there's just so much going on. The Great American Bash right around the corner. In 2 hours, Larry Legend, of WCW Monday Nitro, that will change the course of history, the way sports entertainment is watched on television.
In fact, this Monday night, a special close-up look at Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green.
Ah, stop it. You're going to make me start laughing again. You know, when some neophytic moron got into the ring, we always referred to him as being green. Seems like Kevin has got the right name as far as Dumbo's concerned. Green and Dumbo couldn't even get in there and have a good chance against the Southern Posse, let alone two of the four horsemen. Well, what a joke.
That's Sonny Trout of the Southern Posse being manhandled.
You know, the nice part about last week's Nitro was McMichaels wasn't on it.
Well, I tell you what, you know, talking about Southern Posse right here, Lord Steven Regal and the Squire not having too much of a problem right here.
Oh, a drop kick there by Regal.
On WCW Pro this morning. I guarantee, and I'm going to tell you what, talk about, I got my different thoughts in Larry, and I'm going to bring him up later on, because I played football also, and I wrestled. And I was the heavyweight world champion as Larry was, and I played football too. So there's a real storm of ruin on the horizon. Ric Flair might have bit off more than chew.
We're going to see Brad Armstrong in action this morning. He's coming off tremendous victories over Jushin Thunder Liger. And, of course, he defeated Dean Malenko, currently the WCW Cruiserweight Champion. He defeated him in the early rounds of that tournament. So Brad Armstrong is on a roll here in WCW. Look at that move there by Squire David Taylor.
But Squire puts any more leverage on that chin, you're going to be rolling the Southern Posse's head along the mat. Here, tagging Regal. Squire puts the man in the corner. Great ring positioning. And Lord Regal, love him or not, great mat technician.
Lord Steven
Regal. Can you
Regal.
Imagine what Regal would do to McMichaels or Green?
Well, we're going to see what he can do to Sting tonight on WCW Saturday night. That's right, Lord Steven Regal against Sting. Still that question mark as Barbarian is supposed to face Randy Macho Man Savage and the American Males against the Steiner Brothers tonight on WCW Saturday night. And Regal being battered now by the Southern Posse.
He just got cut off, though, by the Squire coming in. Great tag team work. These two guys really know what they're doing. They need to forget what happened in the past, get themselves together if they're going to make a run at the world's tag team title. Sting and Luger, I guarantee you, somewhere down the line, Sting going to realize that Luger is not in his best interest.
Oh, how can you say that?
Easy, it just came out of my mouth. Somewhere down the line, he's going to realize that Luger's not his best interest.
If it wasn't for Lex Luger, Sting would not be here as we speak after that match he had with the Giant.
If it wasn't for Lex Luger, Sting would have been the world's heavyweight champion. Let's go on about our big
now, the whip there. Regal goes up and right back body drop. Flat on his back. In fact, this Monday night on the first 2-hour WCW Monday Nitro. Look at that clothesline. Indeed, it is going to be Sting along with Lex Luger in his corner against Scott Steiner with Rick in his corner. What if, Dusty, Sting realizes at that point, what if Lex Luger is not the man that Sting should be teamed up with? Then what is Sting going to do at WCW Monday Nitro?
How can you even ask the stupid question like that? Nice reverse suplex there, but hey, if it wasn't for Lex Luger, there'd be no tag team championship on Sting. There would be no Sting.
And the nice tag right there, lost Steven Regal getting in. The Squire's there. Trying to put him away. Got him in an unclean position right here. Maybe going to try to cross-face him here. Larry's talking to him. No filibustering too long. Hooks him up.
Oh, he's pulling up on that head right there. This guy's not going anywhere but the dressing room.
And very quickly, that is the end. It's Lord Steven Regal and Squire David Taylor. Regal doesn't even want to be touched there by the referee.
Put the uncle on him right here on WCW Pro this morning. Hot and heavy with a big boy's play.
With the Regal roll as Regal rolls into WCW Saturday night. Tonight, against Sting and the American Males against the Steiners and the big question mark. Will Randy Macho Man Savage be on TV tonight? Let's take another look at our slow motion instant replay. It is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, 1-800-COLLECT. Call from any phone to any phone and save.
You can call from Buckingham Palace and get his lordship right here. He may turn around, though, and get you. Got the Southern Posse right square, flat smack dab in the chin. Down he goes. Look at the eyes. Regal's got eyes like a hawk. Knows where he's at all times. Know where Dave Taylor is. And right there, just making a pretzel out of this kid. But talk about Savage being driven insane. Ric Flair obviously did the same to Dumbo McMichael. He's driving everybody nuts.
And we're back in a moment here on WCW Pro. DK Wall Street against Mark Starr. Let's take you back to last week's WCW Pro to see how this match came about.
A lot of intrigue surrounding it. This is the weekend. Brothers may turn against brothers.
Well, the Warriors on opposite sides. Yeah. Steiner's on opposite sides. And Wall Street has attacked his own partner. Well, what is he thinking?
Hey, in this case here, I don't blame BK Wall Street. But this just goes to show you. You can't be in there with somebody that don't know what they're doing or know what you're getting ready to do to try to win a match.
Hey, sometimes the young and the useless need a good motivator to snap them out of their ignorance.
Well, clearly accidental there, an error on the part of young Mark Starr. BK Wall Street didn't take to it at all, and as a result, now we've got this match over partners. BK Wall Street and Mark Starr heads up one-on-one against each other.
Well, look at, here comes Mark Starr. Here's a perfect example of a kid that should keep his mouth shut. He thinks he knows what he's doing. He wants to get in the ring and play with one of the big boys. Same way Dumbo and Kevin Green think they're going to get in the ring at the Great American Bash and walk out under their own power.
Now that's Mongo, isn't it?
Well, no, let me make a different point here.
He's Dumbo for getting in the ring with Arn Anderson.
On Saturday morning. Okay, a legend talking about the same line as the Nature Boy Ric Flair was talking.
Yeah.
And pretty soon you're talking just overloaded what you were carrying. And all of a sudden, Mongo McMichael stood up and said, here you are. He said, go get somebody. Nature Boy Ric Flair really thought he was going to get somebody retired. Active player. We're talking about the Panthers in North Carolina, Charlotte, North Carolina. And we're talking about one of the greatest sackers in all of sports. And I love wrestling, and I don't believe anybody can beat a wrestler. Bottom line, though, I play football, too. These two guys are right now. You know why they wasn't in Nitro? Well, like I said, because they're training. They're in deep, serious training for this situation coming up, the Great American Bash, only on pay-per-view on Father's Day.
So Flair and Anderson have been training for years and years. These guys are going to, what, train for a month or so and think they have a chance? What a joke.
Coming up this Monday, the premiere of the two-hour Monday Nitro live, and in fact, a special close-up on Mongo, Steve McMichael, along with Kevin Green, and as you mentioned, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, long-standing team. They'll be facing the American males. The males, what a task they've got ahead of them as they face Ric Flair and Arn Anderson of Nitro, and tonight they face the Steiners. And Mark Starr, not waiting till VK Wall Street faces him, attacks him from behind.
Yeah, he shouldn't wait, because the bottom line is VK Wall Street got into him pretty good, and now then he gets his opportunity right here on the pro show to make amends for it.
VK Wall Street, along with Hacksaw Jim Duggan, eliminated in the second round because they fought each other. They were eliminated by Billy Dick Slater and Robert Deere. Will have eaten the second round of slambery just in the past. And VK Wall Street wondering what's in his future.
He won a timeout.
Well, he should get a timeout. He was hit from behind. I mean, right there, Mark Starr gave it his best shot. Look at that. Wall Street just cut off the momentum, slid out right there. Now he's using the pole for protection. Would you tell these people to be quiet in here?
We've got the giant, the world heavyweight champion, coming up in a moment here on WCW Pro. We're also going to check in with the Slammeree Control Center. The big question, I think, is why Lex Luger got the shot at the giant at the Great American Bash? What if it was Jimmy Hart who's behind all this?
Well, you take a look at the upset of all history in wrestling. Dallas Page becoming Lord of the Ring, winning the ring, winning the Battle Bowl. Upset City. Got to be feeling good about himself from being down so low. How do you think he's feeling now? But bottom line, good call by WCW. Foot was on the floor. I was there. I've seen it. Lex Luger now steps in that situation. I believe Jimmy Hart, Larry, is involved. But let me tell you something, though. The Giant don't believe it. The Giant don't care about Luger because he gave him the most devastating blow I have ever seen on a past Nitro to where he laid him to rest. So if Jimmy Hart is involved, brother, he better get him together.
But definitely a lot of intrigue around Jimmy Hart. The gold seems to follow the man through WCW, no mistake about it.
The Shark, in fact, making the mistake of touching Jimmy
Hart. You know what, though?
Yes.
I mean, right there.
Here comes one, two, and was that a three?
Not quite.
That would have been a big victory.
You're just talking about Diamond Dallas Page, the upset from the gutter.
Yes.
To possessing the ring.
Yes.
Does that mean he could be like the new American dream?
Well, it was like living the American dream because you come from nowhere to obscurity and really come back and do something very important, which he did. But bottom line, he is not at the Great American Bash on pay-per-view against the Giant. It is one big, huge Lex Luger who has more controversy surrounding him than anybody does.
The new American dream.
You like that, don't you?
He has to gain about 400 pounds.
Well, as we said, the Giant coming up here in action on WCW Pro this morning as Mark Starr lays it in on VK Wall Street. The Giant attacking Shark. The Shark making the mistake of touching Jimmy Hart. He was chokeslammed, the Shark was, by the Giant. And now, coming up on Nitro this Monday night, indeed, it is the Giant against the Shark. And this is the premiere of the first two-hour live Monday Nitro.
It's going to take 2 hours to fit both of those men inside of a camera lens. Talk about two huge individuals. That's going to be a big boy's plan.
I'll tell you what, I got some news. I told you I had feelers out on the Macho Man Randy Savage about tonight at WCW Saturday night. Bottom line, they have beefed up security. They have locked the doors already, brother. They are getting ready for maybe an onslaught by the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Yeah, indeed. At this point, he is not supposed to be on television. Essentially been suspended from appearing on television. But he is scheduled to meet the Barbarian tonight. What if he shows up?
Well, I'm he should be arrested again. That's what should happen. The guy's nuts.
Sting against Lord Steven Regal and the American Males against the Steiners all tonight. Beginning at 6:05 Eastern and Mark Starr making a big mistake
now
there.
Time to play.
You know, he's made a couple mistakes. He already tried to choke behind the referee's back, Mr. Wall Street here. But again, he rushed in where wrestlers fear to tread. Wall Street is going to make him pay that tab.
Yeah, Wall Street is too good. If you make a mistake against him, he can beat you. He's the guy we say each and every week comes out, and you see victory after victory. He's always in a situation to where he can win a match, and that's what he's getting ready to do, trying to do right here with young Mark Starr.
He is indeed right in the middle of this thing. Wall Street, a tremendous amateur wrestler, and has had tremendous success as well. Ooh. In the professional ranks, Mark Starr, his partner last week, made a mistake, caused him a match, 1-2, almost a 3, and Wall Street viciously attacking him from behind, as we just saw. Oh, and Starr blocks that, and Wall Street, whatever Wall Street comes up with, Starr seems to have a counter. Laying in those rights, and they're unanswered. Back it off. Wall Street.
He's going to take this there, too.
Well, he's laying him in again. Look out.
He's stumbling on him now. Got to put him away. Hey.
Pulls the tights, and he's got the ropes. He got the 3.
Well, once again, we talk about victories. He got another one.
Well, BK Wall Street has been sent along with Hacksaw Jim Duggan, beating the stuffing out of each other at Slambury. That feud has yet to run its course. Defeated Mark Starr here on WCW Pro. We'll take a very quick break. Back with more news about the American Bash, the Great American Bash, in a moment. Heels of Slamboree, we're back at the WCW Control Center, and we're off and running, this time to Baltimore, Maryland, for the Great American Bash. Sunday, June 16th, 7 o'clock Eastern, and available only on pay-per-view. First things first, Diamond Dallas Page is out. In the minds of WCW officials, his foot had touched the floor at Battle Bowl. The championship committee, of course, will not overrule the decision of a referee. They will let Page keep his ring, keep his hardware. However, they have awarded the title opportunity to none other than Lex Luger. The total package now to challenge the awesome WCW heavyweight champion at 7 foot 4 inches, 471 pounds, the Giant, managed by Jimmy Hart. Ever since the Giant captured that title, he has demolished some of the greatest stars here at World Championship Wrestling. Could Luger be any different? He's been rather impressive as of late in his own right. Tell me, guys, did Ric Flair stick his foot in his mouth? Yes, I believe he did, gentlemen. At Slamboree, he challenged former NFL All-Pro defensive tackle Steve McMichael to get a partner to meet Heath Flair and the enforcer Arn Anderson. McMichael brought in none other than former Pittsburgh Steeler and current Carolina Panther outside linebacker Kevin Green. You should have heard Flair backpedal. I believe that was backpedaling we heard, yes. That special tag team grudge has been signed for the Great American Bash, and this is only the tip of the iceberg. It is only the beginning. You're also going to see Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan go one-on-one with Chris Benoit. Falls count anywhere? Is that correct, guys? Please. New cruiserweight champ Dean Malenko to be challenged by second-generation great from Mexico, Rey Mysterio Jr., the son of Rey Mysterio Sr., yes. It's all going to happen at the Great American Bash, Baltimore Sunday, June the 16th, available only on pay-per-view. Here's one you won't want to miss. Was going to be an incredible show, but a Falls Count Anywhere match, a cruiserweight title with Dean Malenko facing off against this young Mexican superstar Rey Mysterio, and of course the Giant facing off against Lex Luger. My question, gentlemen, is what if Lex Luger defeats the Giant for the heavyweight championship of the world? What is Sting going to think? That Jimmy Hart was behind all this?
Who cares what Sting thinks? He had a chance. He couldn't handle the Giant. He should be happy if Lex Luger gets that golden opportunity.
I don't know if anybody can handle the Giant, as big as he is, as powerful as he is, the way he moves around. He is truly the world's heavyweight champion here at WCW. But let me tell you something. He really, on this past Nitro, put Arn Anderson to waste. And you know what? It was funny to see the Taskmaster, Christopher Cruz, when he come out there. But you know what he said? I want to see a fair fight. He got a fair fight. I mean, he got choke slam. I'm talking Arn Anderson right in the middle on this past Nitro. And I guarantee you right now, Stephen Dahl got to be thinking of that.
And of course, it's Lambert, the giant choke slamming Sting, but only after Sting was hit in the head with that megaphone that Lex Luger, oddly enough, couldn't seem to get out of the hands of Jimmy Hart. Very suspicious.
Well, it was an accident. They were handcuffed together. Luger couldn't use two hands on a man. His one hand was handcuffed, and if he didn't have Jimmy Hart's body on that table, the giant would have choke slammed Sting into oblivion.
Are you telling me that Jimmy Hart is stronger than Lex Luger could hold him back from hitting the megaphone?
Jimmy Hart's body fell over the thing. He was hanging there.
No, I'm talking about the blow that caused it all. The ending shot.
And of course, we saw recently Jimmy Hart attacked by the shark, at least pushed around. And then who comes out but the giant choke slamming the shark? As a result, this Monday night, live on WCW Monday Nitro, the first 2-hour Nitro, it is the giant against the shark, as well as Ric Flair and Arn Anderson taking on the American males.
Well, here we go, Stephen Dow. Here's your chance right here. Let's see what he's got.
This guy looks like a doll next to the heavyweight champion of the world. Look at the size difference. Steve Dow's a big guy, too, but he looks like a baby out there.
The giant, keep in mind, 7'4", 456 pounds. He said he always knew from the very earliest times that he had a consciousness about him that it was his destiny to become the heavyweight champion of the world.
Right. Look at right there. This guy sticks his leg out. He's almost in the other corner.
You know, we talk so much about WCW Saturday night and what we're getting ready to see right here. If you watch the Power of the Giant, let me tell you something. We're also going to talk about Hulkamania tonight on Saturday night. Take a look at him out in Hollywood. Celebrities surround him. Hulkamania really has to be watching this thing with one eye open. I guarantee you, because they have set the table for the Giant right here, brother.
Oh, a drop kick there by Steve Dahl. Doesn't get the big man down. Second one. A third one, and he swats him away like he'd swat a mosquito.
Look at this. Uh-oh. Look at this. This is it. This kid's going up.
There he is.
The same move that he is using the shark on Hulk Hogan, on Lex Luger, on Sting, and recently on Arn Anderson. In fact, in a moment, we'll take you back to this past week's WCW Monday Nitro to show you what the Giant did. And also, what so much more happened on Nitro as we get ready for 2 hours each and every Monday night live as the Giant victorious here on the floor.
See, I told you, Jimmy Hart, a mental giant. And the giant himself, appreciative of the fact that this man took him all the way to the goal that was Hulk Hogan's when Jimmy Hart managed the Hulkster. But now, Hulk, Nobel giant champion, is there a common denominator here? Yes, there is. The man's name is Jimmy Hart.
Let's see this again in our slow motion instant replay. Devastating move.
Well, it picks him up like a piece of paper. Same effortless chokeslam we've seen him use against Arn Anderson and the shark, who's 500 pounds. Who can stand against the beast?
Well, we're going to see the giant against the shark this Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern, live on the first 2-hour Monday Nitro. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson take on the American males. In fact, Ric Flair is here on WCW Pro this morning in our main event. We're also going to see one of the toughest, roughest, meanest Japanese stars of all, Masachono. All that and a lot more now. We take you back to WCW Monday Nitro. I'm sure if you surfed the internet this past week, you've got to be aware of the rumor, regarding the possible retirement of arguably the greatest star professional wrestling has ever known. This man actually has been involved in a myriad of careers, I guess, over the years, and maybe, just maybe, he may want to move on to other things. Where would he go? What would he do? I talked to this monster superstar just yesterday, and I'm going to have the real story for you all day today on the WCW Hotline. Get the scoop you won't get on the internet or anywhere else. Call the WCW Hotline at 1-900-909-9900. 1-900-909-9900. Call right now.
Okay, back to action. Bruce the Dream, the legend, gentleman, Masahiro Chono, has made a tremendous reputation for himself in Japan, and he is right here on WCW Pro.
One of the finest athletes to come out of Japan. I've seen him on numerous occasions, have been over there before I retired. When he was a younger guy, got in a situation where I was in the ring with him and Saito. This guy has all the tools, and he is a great athlete.
He's also mean, nasty, and he loves to hurt people. All the necessary ingredients And you know, talking about the Great American Bash, Dumbo, McMichael, Kevin Green, they're going to find out the hard way how to make people suffer on that mat. You know, I'm from Pittsburgh. Yeah. Kevin Green, I don't know what he thinks about himself, but here's a guy that lost the entire Super Bowl so badly by himself that the team traded him to the Charlotte Hornets. They got rid of him.
Let me handle
Kevin this. Green's a loser.
To the Charlotte Hornets.
Let me handle this before we watch Sean right here. I mean, he's so knowledgeable about so many things and so knowledgeable about less things. Bottom line is they played the Dallas Cowboys. I'm from Texas.
So you couldn't even be a Cowboy.
And now I'm going to tell you something. These guys train year-round, and I know Mongo McMichael, my homie from Austin, Texas. He is training, going to be ready, and Kevin Green's going to be ready. Ian Anderson, it's your boy Ric Flair. Why didn't they trade the whole team? I mean,
because Kevin Green was the bad one.
The bad seed of what?
Of the team.
Oh, legend.
You know, let me tell you something else, football players. Shut up.
Well, it's not the Charlotte Hornets.
Let me tell you something else, football players don't realize. You know, they do a play and last, 10 seconds? Then they all get back in the huddle and suck their guts in and out. Wrestling match, boys, they ring the bell. You don't get timeouts. You don't get huddled. The play don't last 25 seconds. These guys are going to be dead before the 15-minute mark if they get that far.
When the Charlotte Hornets.
It's a North Carolina Panthers. Let me tell you something. When Mongo McMichael sacks Ian Anderson in the middle of the ring, they better check his draws.
It's going to be the Great American Bash live and only on pay-per-view, fans. Make that all-important call to your local cable company. What if Lex Luger defeats the Giant at the Great American Bash? What is Sting going to think about that after having been defeated by the Giant? Oh, what a big boot by Masahiro Chono.
Yeah, what's Butch Long's dentist going to think when he sees this kid's mouth? What a shot.
Masahiro's compatriot, sometime partner in Japan, Shinjiro Otani, having won the WCW Cruiserweight title, now having lost it to Dean Malenko, and Malenko at the Great American Bash featuring the incredible, incomparable Mexican superstar Rey Mysterio Jr.
I tell you what, Chono has held every major title in Japan and some in other countries, and he is a tremendous athlete to be reckoned with. But there is so much happening. Me and Larry talking football and wrestling back and forth. The Great American Bash on pay-per-view is going to be something. Bottom line is, just got another note before we came back from break. You guys know, they have told me that tonight that the building is being actually cut. They're actually padlocking the building because the Macho Man is on a rampage. Scheduled to be there tonight on WCW Saturday with the Silver Tongue. Tony Schiavone doesn't want the American Dream. But will he be there? I don't know.
Well, Chono wasn't there. This kid hit the pole. Talk about attacking Chono from behind. I think Sonny Ono
did what? Snaked him in the grass.
He didn't snake him in the grass.
Chono attacking Butch Long viciously outside the ring. Long making a major mistake there a few moments ago. Sonny Ono enjoying the festivities, as he would call them.
Well, you see the difference here with Chono, and you see the other Japanese wrestlers. They go in and they mat wrestle a whole lot. Chono is from that school where he can do all that, but he is vicious. He can take you out and take you to task. Learned a lot of that from Masa Saito, Mr. Tacha.
Whoa! Oh, man. And Butch Long's offense, I believe, has come to an end here as Masahiro Chono, also physically dominant. Chono just taunting Butch Long. You mentioned tonight, WCW Saturday Night Savage against the Barbarian. At least that's how it's scheduled. Right through his chest. Sting will be there in action against Lord Steven Regal and the Steiners as well tonight, all on WCW Saturday Night, and he does it again.
And don't forget that look at up close and look at the man himself, Hulkamania Hulk Hogan.
Yes, indeed, tonight, 6:05 Eastern, and this could do it.
Turn him over.
The STF. The step over, toe hold with a cross face. Yes. And that is going to do it. Masahiro Chono.
Look how he pulls back on it. Just gets the leverage right over there by the eye socket. Knows how to make people suffer inside that ring. This Sonny Ono would keep them checks coming.
All right, we're going to see that again as Masahiro Chono, so victorious and so dominant here on WCW Pro, and Sonny Ono, oh so happy. Well, apparently we're not going to see that again. We're going to continue here. We're going to stay. Wait a minute. Sonny Ono getting physically involved here. He is walking the edge.
Okay, they already rang the bell.
Player in the main event in a moment. Don't go away.
Yeah.
favorites. Our main event this morning in the Pro, Ric Flair against Brad Armstrong.
You're looking right there. Brad comes in. Flair backs up to the rope. Knows how to use the ring as his ally. This man's made a home of that squared circle. And what chance is Kevin Green and Dumbo going to have inside with two great players of chess like Flair and Anderson?
Well, Dusty, that's a question. Well, what if they do defeat Ric Flair and Arn Anderson?
Well, football players are taught to explode within a 10-yard period. When you play football, you're playing for 10 yards, and you're exploding during that 10-yard period. And right here, that ring is not 10 yards wide. Bottom line is these two guys are big. They are in the serious training. They have trained all your life to be professional athletes. And yes, I say wrestlers are the toughest of any sports, Larry Zbyszko. I guarantee you that much. But when you bring a guy's laundry out the street like Nature Boy did with the Macho Man Randy Savage, and now has done with Mongo McMichael, then you got more adrenaline going to go past the realm of learning how to wrestle. It's going in to hurt somebody, and that's what Kevin Green and the Mongo are going to do.
Well, if the football players explode like missiles, and after they explode, they go up so high, they fizzle out and fall down to the ground. I mean, just because, what's his name, Dumbo?
No,
Mongo?
That's what you call him most of the time.
Just because McMichael is upset that his wife likes Ric Flair.
Well, that ain't
true. No reason for self-destruction.
That is not true.
As far as we know, there is no basis in fact for that assertion. Indeed, Mongo McMichael's wife has been doing everything she can to stay away.
Of course she has. That's why she's always by the steel rail.
We saw it at Slamboree. Ric Flair and Macho Man Randy Savage, ostensibly a team, but Flair did everything he can, everything he could, to drive the Macho Man insane. A beautiful dropkick there.
You know, McMichael's going to realize the same thing. Flair could do the same thing to him. He's going to use all McMichael's alimony to party with.
Well, Ric Flair is on a roll this past Monday night against Eddie Guerrero. We saw Eddie Guerrero's knee get damaged in that match against the Nature Boy as Ric Flair teams up with Arn Anderson to face the American Males this Monday on the first two-hour Monday Night Show.
Well, they got them devilish women out there. I'll tell you something about Brad Armstrong, though. He watches tapes, and I guarantee you he was watching Nitro. Don't want to make the mistakes, Eddie Guerrero, because Eddie Guerrero gave Ric Flair all he could handle, my friend.
Indeed he did, and of course that special close-up look at Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green this Monday night beginning, mark it down, 8 p.m. on our sister network TNT. Also, check this out, Sting along with Lex Luger in his corner against Scott Steiner with Rick Steiner in his corner. All happens this Monday night on TNT. An action-packed 2 hours, and it is live, and it's the first of 2 hours. What's next? 3-4 hours? Who knows? As the demand for WCW almost unquenchable.
I'd like to see it all night long. Flair, he went down, but look at, he knows where to go.
Yeah, well, he's a little frustrated because Brad Armstrong will not be intimidated by the Nature Boy Ric Flair right here this morning on the Pro. Will not be intimidated. These devilish women can talk all they want. But Brad Armstrong is loaded and ready to go.
He looked at the best laid plans of mice, and Armstrong still can't hold down the Nature Boy for long.
A tremendous showing by Brad Armstrong against Diamond Dallas Page this Monday night. Also got all the way to the finals in the Cruiserweight title. A lot of people believe the Cruiserweight Championship may be his someday. A knee lift there by the Nature Boy.
Boy, and Flair set him up perfect for that, too. Armstrong came in high, left his midsection wide open. Flair was right there. And again, Armstrong, great moves, even good with combination, but some type of intestinal fortitude challenged individual.
Got him now.
Just
rolled
can't
him up.
Put him away. Kick out of that.
He's got him rolled up. Indeed, 1-2, almost a 3. And right back out of the mat. Speaking of Macho Man Randy Savage and what Ric Flair has done to him emotionally, personally, physically, and financially, Dusty, some real question about tonight's WCW 79.
Hey! The referee to disqualify himself.
Well, we already talked about the anticipation about Saturday night and what surrounds the building. More or less, we talk about what goes inside, but the beefed up security, everything intact. Wondering if the Macho Man Randy Savage is going to be there after being suspended from wrestling on all WCW television programs. But remember this also, he has the opportunity in the arenas across this country where we go live, brother, to do some dastardly deeds to the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Believe me, he is loaded. Will he be suspended from that too? Only time will tell.
Well, he should be suspended forever from everything.
Why,
no emotional control whatsoever. Nothing to do with professional athletics. Well, he went for a ride.
Wow. Get him red.
Macho, beautiful drop kick there by Armstrong. Make that.
There you go. Get away from this situation.
The 54 inside cradle. One, two, and almost a three count there by Armstrong.
Yeah, that was close again. Nice move by Armstrong. And hey, there goes McMichael.
That was not McMichael.
Ric Flair has chased Wildcat. Talk about lack of emotional control.
Yeah, you know what?
Wildcat really has no control either.
I'll tell you something, though. Red Armstrong has got to make about Ric Flair a little flustered.
Indeed he did. I wasn't sure Wildcat Willie could move that kick.
You know, in woman, you got to watch Elizabeth all the time because she does dastardly things. But that devilish woman, she can take off a high heel, she can kick it, she can punch it, she can scratch it, she can do anything. And she is truly devilish.
Boy, again, notice how Flair used that corner, kept the momentum, but stopped in the corner. Armstrong followed him in. That's a sucker play. And Flair got him again. Armstrong fell for it. I think that's that lack I'm talking about. Armstrong always makes too many mistakes.
Exchanging chops here, and Flair getting the better of it, although Armstrong, he decides to throw some less. That's 4-5, and a big one makes 6, and Flair goes down.
There you go, deal on him. Deal on him, kid.
Armstrong doing just about everything right here against the Nature Boy. All the wet. Oh, Flair flipped off, but he hangs. No. He was going to hang onto that top rope, and Armstrong follows him out. Good move.
Yeah, you need to be careful now when you follow him out because Ric Flair's always there to cut you off. So smart. So smart.
Up and over.
Grab the rope.
Is Flair going over? Indeed, there he grabs the rope. Now the referee kicks it off. And the ladies, woman and Elizabeth screaming.
That woman's screaming, man. Somebody ought to put a cock in her. I guarantee you. Oh, God, you're crazy.
Oh, drop kick off the top, cover him. Got to know when to put him away now, Brad. That should do it. 1, 2, and 3.
He can't do it. The Armstrongs can't do it, I told you.
And Flair begging off, but look out, Brad Armstrong. Flair is the most dangerous when he is in the most trouble, and surely he is in the most trouble right now. The side Russian leg sweep. That's how Brad Armstrong defeated Jushin Thunder Liger. Here comes one.
Hey, he put his foot on the rope, Rip.
His foot was on the rope. It was put on there by Woman, apparently.
Well, don't turn your back on him now, Brad. You gotta continue doing what you were doing. Stay on top of your game. Get her down. Get her down.
Well, he's got him rolled up. 1, 2, and again a kick out by Flair. Oh, look out. He's got something in his right hand.
But look at that. We've got a shot of that.
The referee saw it.
There you go. There you go. Yes, he did.
Wait a minute.
Yes, he did.
Wait a minute. The referee didn't see the first possession. Possession is 9/10 of the law.
Well, the referee should have been disqualified here.
He should have been disqualified when he pushed Flair.
Screaming like in the bed.
Well, that's it. Don't put her in front of the judge.
Well, you deny everything all the way to the end. That's what I heard.
Well, she's got a lot to be sorry for.
I'm sorry. Everybody saw Brad Armstrong got a victory. Everybody saw him, but Brad Armstrong. He got a victory. He'd be out there tonight partying, maybe limousine riding, champagne drinking. Brad Armstrong.
Well,
it wasn't a clean cut
victory.
Well, it
Flair
was a victory.
Flair had Armstrong in trouble from the get-go. Armstrong hit a couple of nice moves, had 3 or 4 opportunities to pin the Nature Boy. Just couldn't do it.
The American males take on the Steiners. Sting against Lord Steven Regal. And will the Macho Man be there? We'll find out tonight.